Health and Human Services, Health Resources and Services Administration.
Back here from the Convocation Center in DeKalb, Illinois, home of the Northern Illinois Huskies for today's matchup between Northern Illinois and, of course, your Bowling Green Falcons. Bryn Lowe, Lucas Kleinmeier back with you here on behalf of Falcon Media Sports Network at BG Falcon Media. And before we get things underway, let's take a look at the starting lineups first for the 13-12 Northern Illinois Huskies. They'll go with the 5'10 redshirt junior out of Cedar Rapids, Iowa, Sidney McCray. The 5'6 senior out of Bolingbrook, Illinois, Jaden Marable. The 5'9 senior out of Wilton, Iowa, Courtney Drake. They'll be joined by the 6'3 senior, Brooke Stonebreaker from Versailles, Ohio. And then rounding out the starting lineup for the Northern Illinois Huskies will be the 6-foot redshirt freshman from Northbrook, Illinois, Brooke Blumenfeld. On the other side with Bowling Green, you've heard it before, the same starting lineup back once again from last game. The 5'10 fifth year from Granville, Ohio, Morgan Sharps. The 5'7 junior from Centerville, Ohio, Amy Velasco. The 5'8 freshman from Olmsted Falls, Paige Kohler. The 6-foot senior from Palatine, Illinois, Olivia Hill. And the starting lineup completed by your player to watch today, the 6-foot senior from West Windsor, New Jersey, Erica Porter.
Yeah, Brandon, I think just one quick note for the Falcons. I think we failed to mention in pregame, Paige Kohler has been an Ironman for this Falcons team just as a freshman. She's started all 24 games this season, make it 25 now this afternoon. She's averaging about over 33 minutes for Bowling Green and averaging 11 points per game. Got 83 assists on the season as well. She's had a great freshman campaign.
And, of course, I don't want to sound the alarms too soon, and I don't get a vote in it at all, but if we were voting on MAC Freshman of the Year today, Paige Kohler would have my vote.
Yeah, she absolutely needs to be in the consideration when you look at the other freshmen in the MAC that have been performing. There's been a couple. There hasn't been a lot this year, and Paige Kohler's definitely been one of the top elite ones in that top tier.
So we are just about ready to go. Bowling Green out onto the floor. They'll go with their white uniforms, orange numbers, and trim. And Northern Illinois, they will be in their blacks with the red lettering. 10 minutes loaded up onto the board. The starting five is headed towards the timeline. As we get ready to tip things up here, we mentioned the first matchup, Bowling Green won by 18 earlier this season, but Northern Illinois catching heat at the right time. It'll be Stonebreaker and Porter to take the opening tip. And we are live. Bowling Green going to have the basketball first. Off the tip, it goes to Morgan Sharps, who immediately pitches it back to Velasco. Now here's the basketball in the hands of Porter before it goes to Kohler. On the outside, the freshman working toward the right wing finds Sharps back once again, top of the key. Looking inside, Erica Porter inside to the bucket. First bucket of the game for Bowling Green.
And Erica Porter's really found a lot of success during the second half of this season in the paint, working down low. And you see, right there.
Here comes Northern Illinois up the floor. Marable the basketball, trying to go inside. Velasco there with some defense. Hill going to provide some help as well. The double team gets the steal for Bowling Green. Here comes Velasco leading the charge. Kohler calling for the basketball. Is going to get it now on the right side. Guarded by Marable, now into Porter. Porter going to try to go one-on-one inside again on Blumenfeld and gets it to go. Erica Porter, the first 2 buckets of the game, just like she had on Wednesday at Akron. Here's Marable across the timeline. Northern Illinois comes back up the floor. Didn't get a shot off on their first time down the floor before the turnover. They're going to get a shot off this time up the floor, and that's a straightaway three-pointer from Courtney Drake.
And Courtney Drake started most of the games this season, lost her starting spot for a stretch this year, but she does have 35 assists, which is third on the team.
Velasco now with the basketball once again for Bowling Green. Here come the Falcons up the floor, the freshman working it on the perimeter. Kohler looking down low, trying to find Porter. Foul going to be called down low. And where's it going to go? It will be assessed to Brooke Stonebreaker.
And Stonebreaker, if you're a Bowling Green player, that's one player you want to get in foul trouble, like we mentioned in the pregame. One of the keys for the Huskies and very influential.
Velasco on the baseline, gets it into Kohler. Here's Kohler working it out. Now on the outside, a little back and forth with Velasco. Kohler rattles home a three. And Bowling Green, a nice start from the field here. They're 3 of 3. 7-3, Bowling Green leads a minute and 40 seconds into this game. The Huskies have the basketball now. Again, it's Drake on the outside. And this time it's going to be Paige Kohler calling for the foul.
Falcons foul, number 10, Paige Kohler, her first.
Yeah, it was a good look there for the Huskies on Drake. Kohler just a little late to meet Drake and gets charged there for a foul.
So Drake inbounds right there for Northern Illinois. Ball finds its way into the hands of McCray. Sydney McCray continues to work the perimeter. Now here's Blumenfeld going inside. There's the chance, and Brooke Blumenfeld able to get a basket as well. Gets in on the scoring effort here early as this game's now 7-5. Sharps on the outside, a quick look there on the pump fake after the pass from Velasco. Here's Kohler, now Velasco once again inside, gets it to go. Bowling Green, all money here to start this contest. Marable trying to cut inside. Here's Blumenfeld once again going inside over the top of Hill. Left it off to the left. Both teams after the rebound. It winds up in the hands of Kohler. Here comes Paige Kohler surveying up the floor. Finds Amy Velasco wide open for three. And Velasco not going to miss that one. Just like that, it's 12-5 Bowling Green. 2 minutes and 45 seconds in. McCray, the basketball here, worked into the charity stripe. Now back out, Stonebreaker. Here's Marable. Marable trying to work in off the left side. Double team there, turned her away. Now she gets the ball back on a back and forth with Stonebreaker. Outside, Drake going to try another three. Left that one short, and Sharps will just let it carry out of bounds on the baseline.
7-point lead right now for the Falcons, Brandon. To start this game, offensively, their decision-making has been very quick and efficient shooting as well to start this game.
So here, Velasco and Sharps out of the backcourt, side by side. Velasco to Porter, back outside. Here's Kohler. Kohler too long on the three, and that one was wildly off to the left side.
Maybe another part of the commentator's curse right there just said Bowling Green's been shooting efficient to start the game. Unfortunately, there from quarter, just from Kohler, just off the mark there.
5 of 5 to start. That's the first miss down the floor for Bowling Green. 12-5, the lead remains. McCray back on the offense for the red and black. Inside, a travel going to be called as Blumenfeld was fed the basketball, and that'll turn things back over to Bowling Green. So Hill will give in to Velasco off the Northern Illinois turnover. Bowling Green brings that 7-point lead up the floor, 12-5. Over 3.5 minutes in now. Kohler at the top of the key, looking to the left side. Here's Sharps going to work on McCray. Down low, Porter on the left side, draws the double team back out. Velasco going to try the three once again. That one too long off the back tab. We will get a foul called under the basket, and it will go against Erica Porter.
And that's the one thing Erica Porter's got to watch out for. Sometimes she can get into foul trouble too early in games, which caused her to get taken out. With the Bowling Green's lack of depth and a lack of players of her status that can go inside the paint, she's got to watch out for silly fouls like that.
And as Bowling Green came back down the floor to defend, assistant coach Nick DiPillo looked at Porter and said, you got to be patient. Blumenfeld has the basketball knocked away once again. Back outside, they're able to get it to Drake as they recover, and Courtney Drake recovers the offense as she buries another three. So 12-8 now, still a two-possession game in favor of Bowling Green. Porter back to Velasco. Here's the handoff into the chest of Kohler. Kohler looking to Sharps. Thought about a catch and shoot. Little pump fake there. Back to Kohler. Top of the key. Three-point try. Comes up off the mark once again, and it will tool off out of bounds. Northern Illinois basketball. Kind of surprising 4.5 minutes into this game that Morgan Sharps hasn't taken a shot yet. But again, you mentioned being the scoring leader the first time out and doing what she's done lately in terms of getting hot from shooting the three ball. Certainly Northern Illinois would probably opt to defend her a little tighter.
And usually when you look at the box score at the end of the game, Sharps usually attempts the most shots. And unfortunately for the Falcons, haven't gotten her any looks early on.
Brooke Stonebreaker hits in a low post bucket for Northern Illinois. Now it's 12-10. Bowling Green still does lead. The Huskies have been able to chip into that over the last couple of minutes, however. Sharps down low, feeds Porter, drawing the double team once again, trying to get up and under. Nice bucket there from Erica Porter.
Really good movement there, really good use of her body, good angles, and getting that one off the glass again as well. She's up to 6 points now.
Next whistle will mark the media timeout here from the Convocation Center, but for now, play continues on. Blumenfeld off to Drake, knocked out of bounds by Bowling Green. It will be Northern Illinois basketball when we come back after the timeout. But before we head to break, we'd like to remind you that all timeouts for the 2023-2024 women's basketball season brought to you by Juniper Brewing Company, located at 145 South Main Street in downtown Bowling Green, featuring coffee and craft beer, serving breakfast, lunch, and dinner. See the latest menu at Juniper Brew. BowlingGreen.com. Bowling Green leads Northern Illinois here from DeKalb, 14-10, your score. You're listening to Bowling Green Women's Basketball right here with us on 88.1 WBGU.
We are live outside the home of Joe and Rosie Goddard, where a pretty big tickle fight broke out just minutes ago. Sources say their father instigated the laughter. Let's go inside for a comment. Apparently, they have no comment. Dads, let this be a reminder that it only takes a moment to make a moment. Call 877-4DAD-411 or visit fatherhood.gov. Brought to you by the U.S. Department of Health and Human Services and the Ad Council.
In the wake of a disaster, what one thing can you send that will help people the most? A blanket, a tent, a sandbag, a doctor. Actually, if you send a monetary donation, you send all these things. Even a small donation can make a big impact and can quickly become exactly what people affected by disaster need most.
In the wake of a hurricane, your monetary donation can make a huge difference to those in need. To donate, visit supporthurricanerelief.org. That's supporthurricanerelief.org. Brought to you by the Ad Council.
Hey everybody, Rachel Ray here. Nothing brings a bigger smile to my face than cooking up a big meal for the whole family and lots of friends. But there's not enough room at my table for the 17 million kids in our country who struggle with hunger. That's why the Feeding America nationwide network of food banks collects surplus food to give hope to hungry kids. But they can't do it without your help. Support Feeding America and your local food bank at feedingamerica.org.
A message from Feeding America and the Ad Council.
Sweet strawberry icing.
You're in Goodwill and just past that vintage denim jacket you spot.
Miniature donut earrings.
You lean in.
Ah, that's the scent of shopping success. Because at Goodwill, every item you buy funds local job training and more. So bring home those donut earrings and bring home so much good to your community. Goodwill. Bring good home. Brought to you by Goodwill and the Ad Council.
Back here from the Convocation Center in DeKalb. Bowling Green leading Northern Illinois 14-10 right now off some hot shooting from the start of this game by Bowling Green. Erica Porter 3-for-3. She's got a team leading 6 points, but Bowling Green overall 6-for-9. They started 5-for-5 and now still shooting at a 67% clip. Definitely the way you want to start the tone to a game.
Yeah, they've just done a really good job of sharing the basketball to start this game. And just look at the assists right now. Bowling Green's got 4 assists, and now you only got 1. They've done a really good job just spreading the basketball around, getting Erica Porter good looks down low. Amy Velasco, Paige Kohler have done a really good job of trying to find Porter. Only player they haven't found looks for so far is Morgan Sharps.
So Northern Illinois inbounding under their own basket after the ball was tipped out of bounds by Bowling Green prior to the break. Northern Illinois shuffles their personnel, but Jaden Marable going to try the three out of the corner. They do get an offensive rebound here. Lauren Nickel fresh into the contest. Tara Stoffaker in as well. Here's Grace Hunter, the third of the substitutions for Northern Illinois. Double dribble going to be called for there, and Bowling Green will take over the basketball.
And Olivia Hill's been excellent defensively to start this game as well.
Olivia Hill into Amy Velasco. Here's Velasco looking inside. Sophie Zekin as Erica Porter gets a break right now. Sharps outside for three. Hits it on her first. We mentioned how it was a little odd that we hadn't seen her shoot the ball yet. Wasting no time here out of the media timeout with 6 minutes gone in the first quarter. Bowling Green leads 17-10. Inside, Stonebreaker looking to get to the basket. A foul going to be called on Zekin there. Some contact with the arm of Brooke Stonebreaker will put the senior at the free throw line. Emily Cecil going to check in for Amy Velasco. So here's Stonebreaker at the free throw line. Unable to get the first. On the season, this Northern Illinois team shooting it at 69%. Stonebreaker 65% at the free throw line. Gets the second for a 50% trip. So now with Velasco out of the game, here comes Kohler as she'll lead things up the floor. Being picked up there by Hunter. Now it's Cecil the basketball. Back to Sharps. Had the defense off balance now inside. Zekin going after it. Too much on it off the glass. And Northern Illinois comes back the other way with the basketball. A two-score game, 17-11. Hunter looking inside. Now Northern Illinois trying to get at the Stonebreaker. Back out, Stoffaker for three. Lights it up from deep. And Tara Stoffaker all sorts of fired up there. Nice little exchange with Stonebreaker on their way back up the floor as they're pumped to cut it back to one possession. 17-14, Sharps now to Kohler. Kohler looking for Cecil on the outside. She'll move it back towards the top of the key. Off to Sharps once again. Zekin trying to clear some space down low. Kohler on the outside, under 10 on the shot clock. Floater from the lane. Nice bucket there for Kohler.
Just once again, good movement there from Bowling Green and good movement there from Kohler. Past couple possessions has been kind of standing still. That was a good movement there.
Marable guarded tightly by Cecil. Gets rid of the basketball. Stonebreaker now beyond the charity stripe. Trying to move in. Gets rid of the basketball. Far side of the floor. Three-point try there. Out of the hands of Marable. Will not fall. Bowling Green quickly up the floor. Trying those stretch passes. Sharps could not get the initial bucket, but Bowling Green an offensive rebound. 2 minutes and 15 seconds left in quarter number one. Zekin the basketball once again off the feed from Kohler. Here's Cecil on the outside, off to Sharps. Sharps being guarded by Nickel, tries the three, too long there, off the mark to the right as well. Here's Marable, trying to drive inside, draws the double team, kicks it out. Working inside is Nickel and gonna be fouled down low by Morgan Sharps.
Yeah, the shot selection there from Sharps was an interesting one because I think Shamil and the Falcons wanted them to kick the ball around a little bit more before taking a shot, and then she goes back to defensive ends, tries to poke away the ball, and just unfortunately gets a little bit of contact there.
19-14, Bowling Green does still maintain their lead. They've had it since the opening tip here in this one. Nickel the basketball off the inbound pass, knocked away from behind by Sharps. The Huskies are able to recover. McCray going to try her hand at the three ball now, and Northern Illinois hits another one, 4 of 6 from deep. Bowling Green having to contest with the three again after playing an Akron team that shot 12 of 25 from behind the three-point line on Wednesday. Cecil on the outside, Taya Ellis to the table to check in momentarily. Kohler looking inside, a foul going to be called on the floor. Looks like that will be away from the basketball almost. And it will go on Grace Hunter. And in comes Tay Ellis checking in for Olivia Hill. Kohler into Zekin off the inbound pass. Back out to Kohler. The freshman looking to go inside. Works it all the way across, back to Cecil. Over and back, gonna be called with the whistle.
Yeah, that's just a sloppy turnover there from Falcons. You can't have Kohler and Cecil there just not on the same page with that one. And I mean, get the Huskies credit. They're making a couple good defensive stands and they've climbed back into this game now, only down by two.
19-17, 1:13 left to play in the first quarter. Northern Illinois looking to tie things up or take the lead this time down the floor. Here's Stoffaker, just inside the perimeter, back off. Laura Nickel moving away, gets by Ellis but lost the basketball. Here comes Velasco up the floor. Northern Illinois had the numbers back. Velasco slowed it down, got it off to Sharps. Sharps tries a charity stripe jumper there and would not fall for. Here comes Northern Illinois quickly up the floor once again. On the outside, quick three-point try. Banks home for Grace Hunter.
You know, we mentioned the Falcons starting this game very well shooting. The Huskies now 5 for 7 from three.
Northern Illinois, their first lead of the game, 20-19, 30 seconds to play, off the hands of Taya Ellis, out of bounds. So Bowling Green struggling over the last 2 minutes as they've been scoreless.
This has been a very high scoring first quarter as well. Both teams have really found their scoring touch in this first quarter.
Half a second separating the game clock from shot clock as Northern Illinois comes up the floor here. McCray being guarded tightly by Cecil, well away from the perimeter. The Huskies working time off the clock here. Blumenfeld comes over to provide the screen, now gets open down low, finds Blumenfeld on the pass. Bowling Green comes up with a big block. Two on the clock, Velasco to the cup and could not get it as time expired. Got it up to the rim, but it would not fall through the hole. Northern Illinois rallies back late in the first quarter to take a one-point lead at the first quarter close. 20-19, the Huskies lead the Falcons. You're listening to Bowling Green Women's Basketball with us here on 88.1 WBGU.
Imagine being fired because of who you love. Imagine being denied medical treatment because of who you marry. Imagine being evicted because of who you are. Millions of Americans don't have to imagine this. They have to live it. Because in 31 states, it's legal to discriminate against LGBT people. Get the facts at beyondido.org. Brought to you by the Gill Foundation and the Ad Council.
To protect her home and family in a disaster, Karen was willing to wade through water, mud, and insurance paperwork.
Yeah, I can do this.
You go, Karen! By simply understanding and updating what her insurance covers and doesn't cover now, she'll be better prepared no matter when disaster strikes. Learn other simple ways to protect your home and family before a natural disaster at ready.gov. That's ready.gov. A message from FEMA and the Ad Council.
BGSU women's basketball, Morgan Sharps, the fifth-year senior guard from Grandville, Ohio, is hoping to have a big year after missing most of last season with a knee injury. Sharps attended Xavier University after finishing her high school career at Newark. After two seasons, she decided to transfer to Bowling Green. In Sharps' first season at BG, she averaged 9.5 points per game, 1.9 rebounds per game, and hit a BG's best 72 three-pointers. The 2022-23 season ended early for Sharps as she sustained a knee injury in mid-January that ended her season. After missing the first few games of the season, Sharps made her debut against Lehigh on November 23rd. In her first game action in over 9 months, she had 15 points, 3 rebounds, and 3 steals versus the Mountain Hawks. This has been 60 Seconds in Falcons Athletics on 88.1 FM, WBGU, Northwest Ohio's community radio station.
Back here from the Convocation Center in DeKalb as the Northern Illinois Huskies lead the Bowling Green Falcons after one quarter of play, 20-19. Brandon Lowe, Lucas Kleinmeier back with you here on behalf of Falcon Media Sports Network and BG Falcon Media. And it was a first quarter, Lucas, in which Bowling Green, they led for 9 out of the 10 minutes, but Northern Illinois, they get some help shooting 5 of 7 from deep. And you know, a big performance from Northern Illinois in terms of the three-point ball, 71% in the quarter.
Yeah, and it's a weird one to sum up because first quarter, like you mentioned, Bowling Green led for pretty much the entire quarter except the final minute, and NIU just had a lot of success shooting the three ball their last quarter. They've gotten three-pointers from a plethora of players, from four different players, in just that first quarter as well. And it's probably going to be one of those games where they're going to have to compete with that three ball because the amount of open looks NIU's created, especially towards the end of that first quarter, is something to look out for.
So 20-19 is how this quarter gets underway. Jaden Marable, the basketball for Northern Illinois, off to Stonebreaker now, working inside, trying to get around Sophie Seekin. Here's McCray on the outside, moves it past the perimeter to Blumenfeld. Steps by Taya Ellis. Nice move there from Brooke Blumenfeld. Just waited for Ellis to go by and had a nice little bunny in short. Velasco right up the floor for three, too long out of her hand. Died off the back iron, but it allowed Northern Illinois to get to the rebound. A series of chest passes up the floor for NIU. Stonebreaker gives it off to Drake. Drake to Marable. Working off the left wing, being guarded by Velasco. Marable goes inside, gets rid of the basketball on the perimeter once again. Stonebreaker had an opening, didn't want to take that three. McCray back to Stonebreaker, through the double team, and a foul going to be called down low on Boltley Green. It'll go against Emily Cecil.
I think an important thing to note as well is Bowling Green had a lot of success with Erica Porter in the paint underneath the basket to start the quarter, and then she took up a personal foul. Jamil and the Falcons took her out, and she hasn't really gone back in yet, and she was the leading scorer for the Falcons in that first quarter with 6.
So Stonebreaker at the free throw line gets the first. We mentioned she was 1 of 2 in her first trip, shooting 65% from the charity stripe on the year, but gets both here. And Northern Illinois extends their lead to 5, their largest lead of the game, 24-19. Here comes Bowling Green back up the floor with the basketball. Kohler looking inside. Back to Cecil. Going to take a 3 here. Emily Cecil crisp with the 3.
And the Falcons really needed that. Cecil ended almost a 4-minute scoreless run there from the Falcons.
Erica Porter and Morgan Sharps back to the table to check in momentarily. McCray on the right wing looking inside. Blumenfeld once again over the top of Olivia Hill. Blumenfeld has got it going on today for Northern Illinois. Up to 6 points on the afternoon. 26-22, Northern Illinois leads. Cecil on the outside once again, off the hill. Here comes Kohler, the basketball, into the hands of Alaska once again. Back outside, Hill with some space, moves it in. Now it's back in the hands of the freshman, top of the key. Here's Velasco working inside through the lane. Amy Velasco, a nice bucket out of the right hand.
There you go, just quick movements, good passing, easy decision making, assertive, and just a good shot selection there from Amy Velasco.
Marable calls out the play. She brings the basketball across the timeline. Now looking in. Here's Stonebreaker once again, trying to go to work on Sophie Zekin. Stonebreaker outside, the pass and a foul going to be called as McCray ended up under Paige Kohler. And Sydney McCray going to go to the free throw line for 3.
And she's only had 3 points to start this game. She hit from three-point range once this afternoon already and shot 3 trips to the line.
So Sydney McCray going to the free throw line. Not super often that you see people go to the line for 3 shots. But I feel like it's definitely happened more in recent years.
For sure, and it's even more rare when you see a player knock down a 3, then get fouled and have a chance for a 4-point play. But I feel like we're even seeing those more now of recent memory as well.
McCray has the first 2. Looking for the trifecta at the line here. Morgan Sharps and Erica Porter did check back in before the initial attempt at the line, and indeed McCray for 3 at the free throw line. So now Northern Illinois' lead back out to 5, 29-24. Cecil the basketball here. Now here's Sharps. The Falcons working the perimeter. Here comes Velasco trying to find some space inside. Amy Velasco going to be fouled there, and now she's going to get a chance at the free throw line. And for Bowling Green, it'll be their first trip to the line for anybody today.
They've done a really good job getting looks for Velasco. 7 points so far this afternoon on 3-for-6 shooting. Hit a 3-pointer as well. Nice hit the charity stripe.
Amy Velasco, one of Bowling Green's better free throw shooters at over 81%, makes the first one there. Settles in here for her second attempt, and just like that, it's a 1-score game, 29-26, as Velasco gets both at the free throw line. Here's Marable once again, this time up the left side of the floor, has an opening all the way in off the glass for Jaden Marable, and she couldn't have made that one look any easier. Velasco back across the timeline for Bowling Green. Here's Porter behind the perimeter, off to Cecil. Emily Cecil, a little step in. Now back outside, Sharps top of the key. Here's Velasco once again, straight away, thought about it. Instead, the pass to Sharps. Morgan Sharps working it around. Down to 7 on the shot clock. Here comes Velasco through the middle again, over the top of Stonebreaker. And Amy Velasco, a nice move with the left hand that time. Up to 9 points for Bowling Green. Marable up the left side once again, going to try her luck there after the last time up the floor. She got an easy basket. McCray lost the basketball. It was knocked away by Sharps. Here come the Falcons. They have the numbers 3-on-1 outside. Sharps steps aside, 1 defender. 3-point try on the way and good.
That's her bread and butter right there for Morgan Sharps. Quick transition off the turnover. Able to find Sharps. Nice little movement there. Look at the wrists.
31 all. Back tied once again as Bowling Green looking to come away with a lead once again. Offensive foul called on Northern Illinois as they come up the floor. And it will be assessed to Stonebreaker as she picks up another. And for Brooke Stonebreaker, that her second personal foul of this half. And Velasco, how about 11 points right now? 4-of-7 from the floor, but Bowling Green really shooting effectively. Still at around that 57% shooting from the floor. Definitely a good start for them. Velasco on the outside finds Sharps once again. Morgan Sharps, another catch and shoot three, buried home.
And I was just about to mention 5 for 10 shooting from the three-point range is pretty good. Now make it 6 for 11.
Both teams shooting the three ball at a very high clip right now. 6 of 11 for Bowling Green, still 5 of 7 for Northern Illinois. They've kind of gotten away from that three here in the second quarter. But Brooke Blumenfeld has been the one that says, that doesn't matter. I'm going to go inside and I'm going to get my points how I get my points. Velasco looking to Erica Porter. Bowling Green a one-point lead, 34-33. 4.5 minutes into this second quarter. Here's Sharps, catch and shoot in the middle this time, and Morgan Sharps looks good right now. That one was smooth out of her hands.
It's 8 points now for Sharps in the last three or four possessions for the Falcons.
Laura Nickel here feeds Blumenfeld on the inside, high off the glass that time. Tried to go with a little 180 spin out of the right hand. Too much on it. It came off the front of the iron. Bowling Green picks up the rebound. Velasco finds Sharps once again. They're going to call a travel on Morgan Sharps that time. And she kind of smiles at the official as she comes back away from the basket. So that will give Northern Illinois the basketball back here. 5:09 left in the second quarter. McCray up the floor here, gets a screen from Blumenfeld, trying to get away from Sharps. Sharps not going to allow that to happen, but a foul going to be called on Sharps. And that will be Morgan Sharps' second foul of the game. And that will take us to the exact halfway point. 5 minutes left in the second quarter, which means we've reached the media timeout. Another one of our timeouts brought to you by Juniper Brewing Company, located at 145 South Main Street in downtown Bowling Green, featuring coffee and craft beer, serving breakfast, lunch, and dinner. See the latest menu at juniperbrew.com. 36-33, Bowling Green leads Northern Illinois from DeKalb. You're listening to Bowling Green Women's Basketball right here on 88.1 WBGU.
Hi, everybody. I'm Jack Hanna. Since I was a boy, I've been fascinated with animals, especially their tireless work ethic. Just look at birds who gather supplies to build nests, or penguins who travel up to 500 miles to secure food for their families. This work ethic is shared by our best friends, canines who perform life-saving work every day. Dogs comfort returning veterans. They work with diabetics, alerting them when there's a change in their blood chemistry. Working dogs are valuable in many ways. So please join me, an American Humane, in supporting our heroic working dogs. Go to AmericanHumane.org to learn more.
The journey of 1,000 miles begins with the first step. At Children International, we know that the journey to end poverty for good begins first with a child. It starts with their first checkup, lesson, opportunity, job. That journey takes commitment from people like you and me to end poverty for good. Learn more at children.org.
I'm a wife,
a sister,
and a grandfather.
I'm an office clerk.
I'm a research analyst,
dance fitness instructor,
actor.
I'm a copywriter.
I'm a veteran.
I have lupus,
cerebral palsy.
I'm blind.
And I'm working in a job I love.
I love.
Because I was given a chance
to contribute my skills and talents.
To show that my disability
is only one part of who I am.
Who I am.
Who I am.
At work, it's what people can do that matters.
For more information, visit whatcanyoudocampaign.org.
Is that a faucet running?
That's not a faucet. That's a river rushing through the forest. Forest rivers provide over 100 million people with clean water to drink.
What? I can't hear you because of the vacuum.
That's not a vacuum. That's the trees in the forest cleaning up the air we breathe.
I didn't know the trees were so amazing.
Yep, and the forest gives us shade, trees to climb.
That's awesome. Let's go explore some more.
Visit the forest today and enjoy all it does just for you. To learn more about the forest and find one near you, go to discovertheforest.org. Brought to you by the U.S. Forest Service and the Ad Council.
Back here from DeKalb, Illinois, inside the Convocation Center as Bowling Green takes on Northern Illinois. The Falcons do have a three-point lead over the Northern Illinois Huskies right now, 36-33. Brandon Lowe, Lucas Kleinmeier back with you here on behalf of Falcon Media Sports Network and BG Falcon Media. So Northern Illinois will have the ball out of the timeout here. Sydney McCray sent inbound from the baseline. And we'll see what Northern Illinois can do. Bowling Green led for 9 minutes back in quarter number one before Northern Illinois took the lead within the last about 30 to 45 seconds of that first quarter. And then Bowling Green, just about a minute ago, just retook their lead that they had back in quarter number one.
And I think a good thing that Bowling Green's been doing this half is capping off off turnovers. Six turnovers for NIU. They got 11 points out of it.
McCray into Brooke Blumenfeld. Blumenfeld trying to go inside on Porter, gives back out. Here's a three-point try out of the hands of Grace Hunter. Off the mark, Blumenfeld the rebound off the underside of the backboard there, and Olivia Hill going to pick it up. Here's Amy Velasco coming forward for Bowling Green, off to Morgan Sharps. Velasco and Sharps tied for the game high with 11 points right now. Slowing it down on the outside, here comes Cecil away from the perimeter. The basketball now with the hands of Velasco. Amy Velasco being guarded by Sydney McCray. A couple steps back right now before Velasco approaches the perimeter. Then the defense from McCray will certainly tighten up. Out on the right side, five on the shot clock. Velasco going to square up and take the three-point try. And Northern Illinois comes up with a defensive rebound there. Laura Nickel off the floor. Here's Nickel, the basketball, looking to go inside herself. Off balance, got it to go out of the left hand. And Laura Nickel makes it a one-point game.
Yeah, it was unlucky there from Velasco. That shot just kind of ricocheted in and out, but NIU capitalizing with Laura Nickel, who we haven't mentioned her name as much this game.
Sharps a catch and shoot three off the outside of the iron there. Here comes Hunter up the floor once again. Grace Hunter looking for an opening off to Stauffacher. Steps inside of Olivia Hill from the left elbow. Lets it go too long. Porter the rebound. Erica Porter now to Amy Velasco across the timeline. Here come the Falcons. Sharps on the outside. Velasco once again. Being guarded this time by Hunter. Velasco steps away once again. She'll come back through the NIU logo at center court. Now the pass off to Porter, just beyond the charity stripe. Porter trying to work her way down low. Emily Cecil gets the basketball now. Sharps to the corner, catch and shoot three. Morgan Sharps let it go but could not hit it. Porter an offensive rebound. Looking back outside, finds Sharps once again. Sharps little pump fake there. Now lets it go. Off to the left this time. Blumenfeld the rebound for Northern Illinois. 36-35, 3:10 left to play in the first half. Northern Illinois does have the basketball. Nickel gets around a screen from Blumenfeld, now tries to get rid of it down low. Porter got in the way and able to take it back for Bowling Green. Here comes Velasco and Sharps. They lead the charge. Sharps for three once again off the mark. So very quickly, Morgan Sharps has missed her last three threes down the floor for Bowling Green. Northern Illinois, they're going to let the three ball fly. That one was way long. Just got glass, no rim out of the hands of Hunter there.
It's been raining threes the past couple possessions or so. Both teams just jacking up threes. And like you mentioned, just Morgan Sharps, can't really blame her for attempting threes. She was 3-for-4 at one point, now make it 3-for-8.
So inside, Bowling Green has the basketball. Velasco now backs away. Down low, they'll go to Porter once again. Porter 6 points in the first quarter. Fouled as she goes up here, and she's going to be headed to the free throw line. And I'll tell you, one of the things that I've talked about over the last couple of broadcasts here for this BG women's team was how much work that Erica Porter has put into her free throws. And you can tell, just you and I sat and watched warm up earlier today. She spent a couple extra minutes early out on the floor working on that free throw shot. So very determined in terms of becoming a more effective free throw shooter. Could not hit the first, just a bit light out of the hand.
Yeah, absolutely. And I think she's just been a better overall player the second half of the season as well. You know, anytime you transfer from a school, it's going to take time getting comfortable in a new school and a new team and a new environment. She's done really good this back half of the season.
Second one off the outside edge of the rim. Northern Illinois touched the basketball on its way out of bounds, so it will be Bowling Green basketball as they get to essentially preserve the possession here. Porter down low off the feed from Velasco on the inbound pass, tries to go to the left side, could not get all of it as it caught the underside of the rim. Back outside, Cecil for three once again, and that one slightly off target. Northern Illinois has the basketball. Here comes Marable up the floor, trying to sprint inside off the glass, right-handed finish. The Huskies have the lead once again.
I think Cecil had more time there on that three than she thought. Had that one off the mark, and Marable able to capitalize off the turnover.
37-36, 2 minutes to play. Offensive foul going to be called on Amy Velasco. Northern Illinois will inbound here. The clock will begin once again after the brief two-minute warning whistle, if you will. Kohler back to the table to check in for Bowling Green. Here's Marable calling out the play for Northern Illinois. Blumenfeld comes over, a decoy screen. Marable gets some separation from the left elbow. Comes up short. Back outside, into the hands of Courtney Drake. Now it'll be Stauffacher going inside. Nice little move inside, but too much on the underhanded try. Amy Velasco has the ball come her way on the floor after some contact from Porter. Able to corral it for the Falcons as they come back up the floor with under a minute and a half to play. Velasco wide open for three. You cannot leave her that open or she'll hit it every time, as she does right there.
And she wasn't happy with the foul that was called on her a couple possessions ago. What does she do next? Knocks down a three.
So we continue to trade the lead now at this point in the contest with 105 left to play, 39-37, Bowling Green leads. McCray, the basketball here, got around the screen from Stauffacher, got away from Sharp. Stauffacher now for three off that ball screen. It came up to the left side. Porter brings in the rebound for Bowling Green. You mentioned how effective she was going to be in terms of rebounding today. Does have a couple of rebounds. Hasn't been super effective compared to last game, but it's hard to match a 16-rebound performance. Does get another one here off the miss from Sharps. Down low, Hill inside, adds two quick ones for Bowling Green. And you saw Bowling Green right there get the rebound and go right back in looking for second chance points, and they got him from Olivia Hill. 41-37, about a second and a half separating shot clock from game clock once again. Marable on the outside calls Blumenfeld out to the perimeter. Blumenfeld sets a screen on Velasco, trying to get it back down low to Blumenfeld. Porter has the basketball. Now they got to get it up the floor quick. Five on the clock. Velasco looking back toward the middle. Gets it to Hill. Hill to Cecil for three. His time expires. In and out from Emily Cecil. Thought she was going to light it up there at the horn. But Bowling Green, they'll be happy to take a four-point lead to the locker room. 41-37 Falcons over the Huskies. We'll take a five-minute break here from DeKalb, and then we'll bring you back for the halftime update. You're listening to Bowling Green Women's Basketball, brought to you right here on 88.1 WBGU.
Everyone knows texting while driving is a recipe for disaster, but other forms of distracted driving, like changing the radio station, putting on makeup, or talking with the passenger can be just as dangerous. This is Trooper Tony Shirley of the Ohio State Highway Patrol's Bowling Green Post. Every time someone takes their eyes or focus off the road, even for just a few seconds, they put their life and the lives of others in danger. Distracted driving is unsafe and the consequences can be devastating. Help us drive to save lives. Never drive distracted.
Adopt US Kids presents What to Expect When You're Expecting a Teenager. Learning the lingo.
Jelly. Jelly adjective. Jelly is a shorter, better way to say jealous, as in, Chloe, I am like so jelly of your unicorn phone case.
You don't have to speak teen to be a perfect parent. Thousands of teens in foster care will love you just the same. Visit AdoptUSKids.org, brought to you by the U.S. Department of Health and Human Services, AdoptUSKids, and the Ad Council.
Hey, Dad, your prescription will be ready in just a minute. Hey, Dad, your laundry will be ready in just a minute. Dad, your lunch will be ready in just a minute.
Hey, honey. Why don't you take a minute?
When you help care for a loved one, you give them as much time as you can. But it's just as important to take time for yourself. AARP can help. Find free care guides to support you and your loved one at aarp.org/caregiving. That's aarp.org/caregiving. Brought to you by AARP and the Ad Council. This is how we do every day. We be
grinding, and if you want to come and text us. If you love them enough to turn off your music and pretend like their music is your music.
Ah, this is mommy's jam.
Then surely you'll check nhtsa.gov/the right seat to make sure they're in the right car seat.
Let's play it again.
Check today at nhtsa.gov/the right seat. Brought to you by the National Highway Traffic Safety Administration and the Ad Council.
It's 4 a.m., Monday, and you're literally sucking baby snot through a tube because she's congested. Man, that's love. And if you love her that much, love her enough to make sure she's buckled in the right car seat. To make sure your child's in the right seat for their age and size, visit nhtsa.gov/the right seat. Show them you love them. Keep them safe. Visit nhtsa.gov/the right seat. Brought to you by the National Highway Traffic Safety Administration and the Ad Council.
Falcon.
Falcon men's basketball faces off against the Miami Redhawks on Tuesday, February 27th. Join FMSN's Tyler Cavalitz and Chaz McNeil on the call at 6:45 for pregame and 7 p.m. for tip-off. Catch the high-flying action on 88.1 FM WBG.
Matt always knew he wanted to be a doctor. That's why he makes the most of every day. To study before breakfast, to work hard, to do whatever was necessary to achieve his goal. He found an answer in the military. If you have a passion, a vision for your future in any field, todaysmilitary.com can be your path to a fulfilling career. You have a calling, we have an answer. Find your way at todaysmilitary.com.
I'm probably okay to have one more drink before I drive home. I'm probably okay. I open the window to stay alert.
Probably okay. I just popped some gum in my mouth.
Step out of the car, please.
I probably made a mistake.
Probably okay isn't okay when it comes to drinking and driving. If you see a warning sign, stop and call a cab, a car, or a friend. Buzzed driving is drunk driving. A message brought to you by NHTSA and the Ad Council.
So I'm a cat, and I just moved in with this new human, and she's got this little toy she's always playing with, all day long. Tap, 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 bloop, bloop. She can't put it down. There it is. Oh, and get this. She even talks to it. Last week, she asked it for Chinese, and guess what? Egg roll showed up, like magic. Humans have cool toys.
A person is the best thing to happen to a shelter pet. Be that person. Adopt. Brought to you by the Ad Council and the ShelterPetProject.org.
This is you over 30 years ago.
Are we there yet? Are we there yet?
And this is your mom now.
Are we there yet? Are we there yet?
Roles change without us noticing. That's why AARP gives you the information to provide even better care for your loved one. Visit aarp.org/caregiving. Brought to you by AARP and the Ad Council.
Back here from the Convocation Center in DeKalb, Illinois. Courtside as Bowling Green women's basketball takes on Northern Illinois. Brandon Lowe, Lucas Kleinmeyer back with you here as we head into the halftime update. Brought to you by the Falcon Media Sports Network and BG Falcon Media. And Bowling Green right now, they lead 41-37 over Northern Illinois. And it's been a half in which the three ball started hot for Northern Illinois early on. Bowling Green worked it in as the game went along, and both these teams shooting about 50%.
It's just been an overall good basketball game, I think, the first half or so. Both teams really started out the game scoring very efficient. Both teams found their form very early on. And like you mentioned, Bowling Green kind of got cold there from three for a little bit towards the start of that second quarter. NIU as well, shooting 5-11 now, which still is pretty decent. They've gotten scores from pretty much everyone that has played this game so far for the Huskies. And if you look at the stats, Brandon, they're not really a lot different between the two teams, except for Bowling Green. They've gotten 11 points off of turnovers. And for NIU, they've gotten zero, so that's a big difference. And then also points in the paint. The Falcons have doubled the Huskies with 16, while NIU only has 8.
And certainly every game pivotal in the sense that there's only 5 games left until the Mid-American Conference Tournament in Cleveland. This being one of those, this being the 5th one of those. After this, there's 2 weeks left in conference play. This is the final stretch. We're coming down to it. Everybody wants to get to Cleveland. And for Bowling Green, you're still trying to move up the ladder in terms of your seeding. And for Northern Illinois, you know, you're in, but you're fighting to stay in right now. You want to be in the middle of that pack as well. And so every game matters, including this one, when you have two teams that are fighting for positioning, really, versus in or out. So for Northern Illinois to start, I mean, the first thing right away to me when we went to break was, you know, the thing that pops out on the score sheet, Northern Illinois, every single player that has played tonight for Northern Illinois has scored.
Yeah, 8 different players for the Huskies have got the basket, and for the Falcons, they've only had one player off the bench that has contributed. Emily Cecil hit a 3 early in the first quarter for the Falcons, and Amy Velasco, Morgan Sharps were the 2 star players for the Falcons in that first half. Velasco leads the way with 14 points from 5-9 shooting, 2-for-5 from 3. Morgan Sharps, 11 points off of 3-from-8 from 3-point range, and 4-from-12 from shooting. Erica Porter did really good to start the game, picked up a personal foul. The Falcons quickly pulled her for the remainder of the first quarter so she wouldn't get any more silly foul troubles. She's gotten her back into the game, and she's been really key, not only as scoring, she's got 4 rebounds as well, which ties the lead right now with Olivia Hill.
And when we look down the roster, and kind of to no surprise, really, I mean, Bowling Green, their starters have been on the floor a lot. It's actually been, you know, considering what she's done recently and her minutes averaged a game, it's been a light day for Paige Kohler. She's only been on the floor for 10 minutes and 50 seconds, but when she's been on the floor, she has been effective. 5 points, four assists. You know, she's doing Paige Kohler things as we're used to seeing in today what has been a limited time for her on the floor.
Yeah, and like you mentioned, 5 points, 2 for 4 shooting, 1 for 3 from three-point range. Does lead the team right now with four assists. Two personal fouls and one sloppy turnover, so there's been a couple uncharacteristic things from Kohler in the first half. She got pulled a couple of times, which is pretty much uncharacteristic with the amount of minutes she's been logging for this team this season, but she'll definitely probably come out to start the second half and pick up right where she left off.
So for Bowling Green, they will look to improve upon their four-point lead out of the halftime break. They led by as many as 7 at one point as the first quarter went along. Northern Illinois, they got out to a 5-point lead. We mentioned sort of a back and forth, but the Falcons will look to continue to lead this game. They won the second quarter. I know they'd like to win the next two as well and come away with a victory here on the day. Will they be able to do it? Only time will tell as we continue to move along here. That will wrap up the halftime update. Bowling Green leads Northern Illinois 41-37. You're listening to Bowling Green Women's Basketball right here on 88.1 WBGU.
I'm a 40-year-old man that walked in there to get his high school diploma. It was very hard for me, but Miss Araceli, she gave me direction.
At age 47, Marco finished his high school diploma.
50% of getting your high school diploma is walking through those doors. The other 50% is doing the work.
No one gets a diploma alone. If you're thinking of finishing your high school diploma, you have help. Find free adult education classes near you at finishyourdiploma.org. That's finishyourdiploma.org. Brought to you by the Dollar General Literacy Foundation and the Ad Council.
A ranger station.
I'd like to report a bear hug.
Okay.
I put out my campfire and Smokey Bear hugged me.
So you drowned the fire, you stirred it. Drowned it again and felt that it was cold?
Uh-huh.
Yeah, but he's just letting you know you did good.
Bear hug from Smokey Bear. Status update.
I'm gonna let you go now. There are many ways to start a fire, but one sure way to put it out. Learn how you can do your part at SmokeyBear.com.
Sponsored by the U.S. Forest Service Ad Council and your state forester.
Long ago, you wouldn't think of galloping on a horse while doing calligraphy. And you wouldn't have attempted to ride your bike while typing a letter. Yet you think you can safely operate a multi-ton vehicle while texting? Behind the wheel is no place to multitask. If you want to BRB, drive now and text later. Lives depend on it.
Visit StopTextStopWrecks.org, a message brought to you by the National Highway Traffic Safety Administration, Project Yellow Light, Noise, and the Ad Council.
The Western Scrub Jay. I was taking my science class on a virtual reality bird watching expedition. All of a sudden, Charlie Kane shouts, "Arr! Arr!" He had spotted the elusive black swift, a bird rarely seen in the wild. For a brief moment, Charlie had not the eyes of a 9-year-old boy. He had the eyes of an eagle.
Teachers just have better work stories. Find out how creative teaching can be at teachdfw.org. Brought to you by Teach and the Ad Council.
Jason and Greg Spurgeon are a pair of brothers on the BGSU men's basketball team who both grew up in Toowoomba, Australia. They both played high school basketball at Toowoomba Grammar School, where the older brother, Jason, was captain of the team twice, and younger brother, Greg, captained once in 2020. Jason, prior to transferring to BGSU, was the leading blocker for Southern Utah University and the second best blocker in the Western Athletic Conference. Greg appeared in 6 games for Westminster Griffins and totaled 5 points, 4 rebounds, and a steal. This has been 60 Seconds in Falcon Athletics on 88.1 FM WBGU, Northwest Ohio's community radio station.
BGSU
BGSU Women's Basketball travels to DeKalb to take on the Northern Illinois Huskies on Saturday, February 24th. Join FMSN's Brandon Lowe and Lucas Kleinmeier on the call at 1:45 for pregame and 2 p.m. for tip EST. Catch all the action on 88.1 FM WBGU.
I'm Surgeon General Jerome Adams. If you've recovered from COVID-19 confirmed by a positive test, you're in a special position to help us fight the virus. Your plasma has antibodies that may help others fight COVID. So please donate plasma now. You can literally help save lives. There are locations across the country that have safe ways for you to donate. Find a site to donate your plasma at coronavirus.gov.
Produced by the U.S. Department of Health and Human Services at taxpayer expense.
Jill, why don't you tell the class what you did this weekend?
Well, my dad and I went in search of some magical minnows and found a zillion of them in the stream from our lookout rock. Then my sister and I escaped from an evil slug king and went back to my super twig fort for safety. Then we told stories till it got dark, and the Big Dipper led us all the way home.
Whoa! Where were you, Jill?
We went to the forest. It's not that far away.
Ask your parents to take you and your friends to the forest this week. It's closer than you think. Check out discovertheforest.org. Brought to you by the U.S. Forest Service and the Ad Council.
I'm a wife,
a sister,
and a grandfather.
I'm an office clerk.
I'm a research analyst,
dance fitness instructor,
actor.
I'm a copywriter.
I'm a veteran.
I have lupus,
cerebral palsy.
I'm blind.
And I'm working in a job I love.
I love.
Because I was given a chance
to contribute my skills and talents.
To show that my disability
is only one part of who I am.
Who I am.
Who I am.
At work, it's what people can do that matters.
For more information, visit whatcanyoudocampaign.org.
Eating, working, living pain-free. These are a few of the things many of us take for granted. But for many adults with disabilities who are elderly or have serious medical issues, dental care is simply unaffordable. Dental Lifeline Network is looking for dentists who can change this. DLN is asking dentists and their teams to volunteer to just see one of the many patients in need. You can literally change a life. Visit willyouseeone.org to help change one life in your community today.
My name is Jim. I'm a veteran, and I lost both legs in Vietnam. My victory was proving that a disability is not a limitation.
I'm Julius. I'm a veteran. My victory was going from homeless to home.
At DAV, we're on a mission, helping veterans of all generations get the benefits they've earned.
I'm Cece. My victory was finishing my education.
When America's veterans win, we all win. Help us support more victories for veterans. Go to DAV.org.
Y'all ready for this? The second half of basketball coming your way from the Convocation Center. Brandon Lowe, Lucas Kleinmeier, courtside with you on behalf of the Falcon Media Sports Network and BG Falcon Media. A loaded day here on WBGU. We've got Northern Illinois versus Bowling Green women's basketball now coming up tonight. We will have the 40th anniversary of the 1984 National Championship hockey team. But Ben Korak is going to be joined by a plethora of guests in the booth tonight, so that's going to be an exciting one as well. Make sure you tune into that one later this evening. But for right now, the second half is underway. Bowling Green a 41-37 lead. Here come the Falcons. They'll start the second half with the basketball. Amy Velasco working on Jaden Marable as she approaches the right wing. Now into the right corner for Kohler. They're going to look down low to Porter here, just as they did early in the first quarter. A foul going to be called on Northern Illinois. It'll go against Brooke Blumenfeld. And Erica Porter going to go to the free throw line.
Not a bad way to start the second half for the Falcons. Erica Porter getting once again another good position down low behind the glass and gets to go to the cherry stripe once again.
The West Windsor, New Jersey native missed both her first time at the line. Gets the first of two this trip. Will settle in again here. Through her three dribble sequence, back up with free throw number two, and that one was crisp on the way through as well. And Bowling Green will extend their lead on the first possession out of the break. Here comes Jaden Marable, the first possession of the half for Northern Illinois. We'll see if they go back to that three ball like they had back in the first quarter. 5 of 7 in that quarter, 0 for 4 in the second. Hill knocks it away from Blumenfeld there. Got it to Porter, a steal for Olivia Hill, and a game that Olivia Hill has been excellent defensively. An air ball three for Morgan Sharps will carry out of bounds. It will be Northern Illinois basketball.
Yeah, off the mark there from Sharps, and Bowling Green now 1 from 9 last three-pointer attempts. Been a little bit cold out of late.
And you don't see Morgan Sharps miss threes like that often. She's taken 153 this year. Coming into this game, that is, and now up over that 160 mark. Here's McCray looking inside. Stonebreaker over the top, tries it with a left hand. It's going to be knocked away by Bowling Green. She got it right back. It's going to be last touched by the Falcons before it goes out of bounds.
Yeah, that was a little sloppy there in terms of rebounding. You had Kohler, Hill, and Porter. They're all in the facility, but none of them really see who's going to come up and get the ball.
57 seconds into the third quarter here. McCray, the basketball on the outside, off to Stonebreaker with the left hand to the bucket, gets through and puts it home. Velasco, the basketball, working out to the left side. Here it comes back to Kohler. A foul going to be called away from the basketball. It will be on Erica Porter down low. And Sophie Zekin going to check into the game for Erica Porter. So Northern Illinois coming back up the floor. Bowling Green a four-point lead, 43-39. A minute and 20 seconds in now to the third quarter. Stonebreaker the basketball on the right side, looking back out, wanted to get it to Drake, but instead going to go one-on-one with Zekin, trying to back her down. Here's the pass to Drake. Northern Illinois trying to get it outside. Here's Blumenfeld trying to move it in. Velasco comes from behind and comes away with the basketball. Amy Velasco cuts up through the middle on the left side, off to Sharps. Back to Velasco, open three-point try here. Comes up just off the mark. Hair short out of the hands of Velasco. Might have been tipped there on the approach by the NIU defender. Here comes Marable into the middle. A high arcing shot from Stonebreaker finds its way down the rabbit hole. And now it's a one-score game. Velasco, the pass to Zekin from the right elbow, back into the hands of the freshman. Here's Kohler away from the perimeter, now moves out to the right side, leaves it off for Velasco. Little bounce pass there, picked up by the junior. Kohler to Velasco, going to try the three once again, in and out. Thought that one was going to fall. And the basketball loose on the floor. Northern Illinois will pick it back up. Bowling Green back to defend.
I think it's just important to note because a couple of possessions back, Velasco did really good there, knocking that ball away to capitalize off a turnover. Then the Falcons go down the offensive end. She attempts a three. That one is off the mark. Then Marable comes back the other way. She hits a three-pointer. And then Velasco and the Falcons come back the other way again, and she hits another three, and that can't get on the go. And the Falcons, 1 from 11 the last three. I'm shocked they're continuing to attempt three-pointers. I thought they would go to the glass to try to get to the mid-range and get an easy basket.
And it looks like Courtney Drake has a little bit of floor burn on the knee that opened up into an open wound. They'll go ahead and get that tended to, and they'll wrap up her knee. And they'll get her mobile right back out onto the floor. Stauffacher going to check in for the Huskies as Blumenfeld comes off. Here is Drake, the basketball, after being tended to by the athletic training staff. Marable steps to the left wing, or to the left elbow, excuse me, tried to go after the deep two there, and had to go after her own rebound after the miss. Touched it last. It'll be Bowling Green basketball here. Amy Velasco up the floor, off the inbound pass from Hill. Velasco out to the left side this time, back to the top of the key. Here's Paige Kohler looking inside, draws the defender in tight. That was Drake, pass to Sharps. Sharps moves in, tries that one on the pull-up. But too much on it there out of the hands of Sharps. Here comes Marable back up the floor for Northern Illinois. Bowling Green cold to start this half. Outside, three-point try for McCray. Too long under the basket and over the back foul going to be called. And no, the foul will instead go on Olivia Hill, who was underneath Tara Stauffacher.
And I was with you. I thought that was over the back of Olivia Hill. Instead, she'll be called for the foul.
Marable, the inbound, gets it into Stauffacher. Here's Drake now, making the move around. Kohler to the inside, fires back out. McCray for three. That one on the way, in and out off the inner portions of the rim. Here comes Kohler off the defensive rebound, trying to work inside. Blocking foul going to be called on Stauffacher. And a good draw there from Paige Kohler.
I like the confidence there from the freshman. Paige Kohler gained that rebound and then quick transition the other way. Attempted, went to the basket, earns the foul, and should go to the free throw line. And right now for the Falcons, they're only 2 points. The start this second half was from Porter from the free throw line.
Only Green 0 for 3 from the floor to start this quarter. 3 minutes and 15 seconds in, Paige Kohler goes to the free throw line and misses the first. Paige Kohler, an excellent free throw shooter throughout her high school and collegiate career thus far, but cannot hit either this time, and a lid on the basket right now for Bowling Green to start this half. Would not be surprised to see a timeout out of Bowling Green head coach Fred Shamil coming if Bowling Green can't get a bucket on their next possession. McCray works it around. Left side, Stauffacher into the left corner. Here's Drake. Guarded by Kohler. Back to Stauffacher. Going to drive the baseline inside this time. Gives it back to Stonebreaker at the charity stripe, and Stonebreaker knocks it down. 43 all. And let's see if Bowling Green can get to the basket on this offensive possession. Velasco looking in. Zekin just inside the three-point line. Back to Velasco. Leaves it off for Kohler. The handoff pass. Now Sharps. Catch and shoot three. Wide open. Morgan Sharps brings a halt to the Bowling Green scoreless run. And Morgan Sharps and Amy Velasco continue to go back and forth. They both have 14 points in this one, so 28 of Bowling Green's 46 right now coming from those two. Inside at the other end, Northern Illinois, Jaden Marable gets a nice bucket there. And it stays within a one-score game. A timeout going to be called here by Bowling Green. One of our timeouts brought to you by Juniper Brewing Company, located at 145 South Main Street in downtown Bowling Green, featuring coffee and craft beer, serving breakfast, lunch, and dinner. See the latest menu at juniperbrew.com. Bowling Green leads by 146-45. We will step aside here from the Convocation Center. You're listening to Bowling Green Women's Basketball with us right here on 88.1 WBGU.
The journey of 1,000 miles begins with the first step. At Children International, we know that the journey to end poverty for good begins first with a child. It starts with their first checkup, lesson, opportunity, job. That journey takes commitment from people like you and me to end poverty for good. Learn more at children.org.
Hi, this is Tom Hamilton, voice of the Cleveland Indians. You're listening to all the high-flying action of Falcon Sports on 88.1 WBGU.
We depend on our drinking water supply daily, but where does that water come from? Your water provider encourages you to get to know your local water source so together we can protect and preserve it. The investments we make as a community to protect our water source now ensure we have a sustainable drinking water supply for the future. Visit drinktap.org to learn more. This message is brought to you by the American Water Works Association and your local water provider.
Every year, millions of Americans use opioids to manage pain, and reliance on opioids has led to the worst drug crisis in American history. That's why the CDC recommends safer alternatives like physical therapy to manage pain. Physical therapists treat pain through movement, hands-on care, and patient education. No warning labels required. When it comes to your health, you have a choice. Choose physical therapy. Visit moveforwardpt.com to find a physical therapist in your area.
Hi, everybody. I'm Jack Hanna. Since I was a boy, I've been fascinated with animals, especially their tireless work ethic. Just look at birds who gather supplies to build nests, or penguins who travel up to 500 miles to secure food for their families. This work ethic is shared by our best friends, canines who perform life-saving work every day. Dogs comfort returning veterans. They work with diabetics, alerting them when there's a change in their blood chemistry. Working dogs are valuable in many ways. So please join me, an American Humane, in supporting our heroic working dogs. Go to AmericanHumane.org to learn more.
Back here in DeKalb, home of the Northern Illinois Huskies, where right now Bowling Green, they're in the Huskies' den, and they're up by a point, 46-45, with 5:41 left to go in the third quarter. Approaching the halfway point, Bowling Green will have the basketball here out of the timeout by Falcons head coach Fred Shamil.
Yeah, and Bowling Green didn't hit a shot from the floor all in that second, third quarter in the second half. I told Morgan Sharps hit that three right before that timeout, so hopefully that shot can start something for the Falcons.
So Morgan Sharps will kick things off here with the inbound pass out of the timeout. Into Hill, back to Sharps. Here's Velasco now. Paige Kohler to the right side, to the basket, and could not get the and one. Thought it was going to roll home for Kohler, but she is going to get to go to the free throw line. Jade Marable will be called for her second personal foul of the game. Three Huskies with two fouls. Kohler, an unsuccessful trip at the free throw line, her last trip. Gets the first one here. You can see deep breaths for the freshman. as she steps away from the free throw line in between shots. Let's the second one go and cannot get that one there. So 1-for-4 for Kohler at the free throw line today. Here's Jaden Maribel out to the right wing, up the floor for Northern Illinois. The pass down low, trying to get it to Stonebreaker. Guarded by Zeke, and Stonebreaker fires across, and that one rifled into the bench as it went through the hands of Nickel.
I mean, NIU hasn't really started up well offensively this half as either. I mean, both teams couldn't really find their shooting to start this quarter, so if the Falcons could get on a run here, they could really pull away.
Both teams just a combined 3 of 10 right now from the floor. Velasco looking out to Sharps. Now here's Kohler. Kohler trying to go inside once again, right-handed at the rack. Gets it to go, and this time, and one. Paige Kohler finding some offense here for Bowling Green. Sydney McCray going to check back in for Courtney Drake. Paige Kohler to the line for the three-point play. The Falcons will bring Erica Porter back in as well. Brooke Blumenfeld going to counter there, checking in for Tara Stoffaker.
And Stoffaker and Porter has been pretty much the matchup on both ends of the floor all afternoon long. And I think Porter's gotten the best of her most of the game.
Erica Porter had 6 points back in the first quarter. Has just 8 now, but her presence down low demands attention. And Kohler gets the three-point play. 50-45, Bowling Green leads, now by 5 points once again, just over the halfway point in the third quarter. Maribel the basketball, looking to the left side, gets it to Stonebreaker once again. Stonebreaker has been the second pass a lot for Northern Illinois. Inside, Nickel loses the basketball. Here comes Velasco up the floor for Bowling Green. Northern Illinois, nice job to get back there and transition into defense. Kohler on the outside, looks in. Here's Porter down low. Right post, back outside, Velasco, Sharps. Sharps gets by the defense, now draws a double team. Blumenfeld comes over, Hill, now Velasco. Here's Kohler once again. Shamil barking out orders from the Bowling Green sideline, right next to the basketball right now. Here goes Kohler to the inside. Nice little turnaround there, left it short off the front of the rim. Here comes Maribel. Maribel and the Huskies up the floor. Maribel thinking coast to coast. Beautiful look there, but could not finish in transition. Kohler has the basketball once again for Bowling Green. The Falcons quickly up the floor. Kohler, floater in the lane, knocks it down this time. Into double figures for Paige Kohler. We mentioned Bowling Green, 4 players averaging in double figures in Mid-American Conference play. They've got 3 there right now. Northern Illinois to the inside. A foul going to be called on Bowling Green. It'll go against Sharps. And for Morgan Sharps, that'll be her 3rd of the game. And we have another timeout coming at you, brought to you by our official 2023-2024 timeout sponsor, Juniper Brewing Company. So pleased to have them on board this season to help make all this travel to each and every Bowling Green women's basketball game possible. 52-45, Bowling Green leads Northern Illinois. We will step aside. You're listening to Bowling Green Women's Basketball right here on 88.1 WBGU.
Crooked teeth may embarrass kids whose families can't afford braces, and trying to fix their teeth themselves can make things worse. Luckily, there's Donated Orthodontic Services, a program from the American Association of Orthodontists. For children and teens who qualify and are matched with a volunteer orthodontist, treatment can be life-changing and help them smile with confidence. Learn more at aaoinfo.org.
Falcons battle against Michigan Tech in the regular season home finale. Join FMSN's Ben Korak and Nick Bowers alongside special guests Joe Borenstein and John Bowers on the call at 6:45 for pregame and 7 p.m. for puck drop. Catch the big game on 88.1 FM WBGU.
A few years ago, Steve Faircow's lungs were failing.
I don't think I had more than a couple weeks to live.
That's when Steve received a lung transplant made possible by an organ donor. Now Steve can do things he never imagined, like climbing 94 floors to the top of a skyscraper.
I never knew that breathing could feel this good. It's an incredible gift.
What could you make possible as an organ, eye, and tissue donor? Leave behind the gift of life. Go to organdonor.gov, U.S. Department of Health and Human Services, Health Resources and Services Administration.
Matt always knew he wanted to be a doctor. That's why he makes the most of every day. To study before breakfast, to work hard, to do whatever was necessary to achieve his goal. He found an answer in the military. If you have a passion, a vision for your future in any field, todaysmilitary.com can be your path to a fulfilling career. You have a calling, we have an answer. Find your way at todaysmilitary.com.
You have the right to know. The right to know about culture. The right to know about the economy. The right to know about technology and to know about sports. You have the right to know about education and politics and the weather. You have the right to know what's happening abroad and in your backyard. But above all else, you have the right to know that this right is under attack, and we must work to protect it. Because in order to be free, we must be informed. Understand the threats. ProtectPressFreedom.org.
Back here from the Convocation Center in DeKalb, Illinois, the Northern Illinois Huskies. Well, they call this place home. In Bowling Green right now, they call themselves in the lead. 52-45, Bowling Green leads Northern Illinois. Brandon Lowe, Lucas Kleinmeyer back with you here on behalf of Falcon Media Sports Network and BG Falcon Media. Once again, a reminder coming up later tonight, we will have the 40th anniversary game for the national champion Bowling Green Falcons on the ice tonight. And you just heard the advertisement there before we came back out of break. Ben Korak, Nick Bowers will be joined by Joe Borenstein and John Bowers, the 84 broadcasters from that national championship season. Northern Illinois at the free throw line, one of two there. 50% trip for Laura Nickel.
And I think one of the biggest stories so far in this third quarter is the performance of Paige Kohler. You know, we talked about at halftime, her not having the type of Kohler performance we're used to seeing, and she's been great this third quarter.
And an offensive foul going to be called on Bowling Green. It will go against Porter. And Erica Porter picks up another foul. That's her third foul of the game. And as Porter comes over to the bench, some coaching points from Fred Shamil. And here comes Northern Illinois back up the floor in a two-possession game. McCray the basketball, guarded by Kohler, pass off. Here's Stonebreaker once again. Blumenfeld trying to get open on the inside. Stonebreaker trying to back down Sophie Zekin. Back to the outside they go. Inside, here comes Hunter with the basketball. Down low, kicks it back out. McCray for three, that one out of the left hand. Sydney McCray, the left-handed shooter, under the basket. Nickel went back up with it, but another foul going to be called. It will go against Bowling Green. That's on Paige Kohler. And Paige Kohler picks up her third personal foul.
And that's something you're used to saying a whole lot. She really does a really good job of staying in a foul trouble most of games. And picking up her third here, and there's a pretty decent amount of time left in this game. It'd be interesting to see what Shamil and the Falcons do.
Porter, Sharps, and Kohler all with three personal fouls right now. Sharps going to head over to the bench as Emily Cecil comes on. Grace Hunter can't get the first free throw. So Paige Kohler of the three with three personal fouls will be the one that stays on the floor for Bowling Green. Here's Hunter once again, second free throw try. That one finds its way through. And Bowling Green's lead is cut to five, 52-47 with 3:05 left to play in the third quarter. Here come the Falcons with the basketball once again. Velasco to the left side, dishes it off to Kohler. Going inside, underhanded layup try, and Kohler gonna be fouled there. It will go on Stonebreaker, and similarly to what we've had for Bowling Green over the last couple of minutes, Brooke Stonebreaker picks up another personal foul. That'll be her third.
Paige Kohler has done a really good job just attacking the rim this third quarter. That's another shot. Where it was a tough shot, it was a tough look, but again, she takes the contact, and now she's going to this charity stripe once again.
And for Paige Kohler this week, one of her NIL deals, her own clothing line, PK10, out. So make sure you check that out. I'm sure she's got it all over her social media. That's where I've seen it. So if you're interested in getting your own PK10 shirt, check out Paige's social media accounts, Twitter, Instagram, all that good stuff, and see if you can get yourself some PK10 apparel. For Paige Kohler, able to get one of two at the free throw line that time, so another 50% trip for Kohler. McCray the basketball here, working out to the left side, going to the basket, twisting underneath, and Bowling Green going to be called for another foul. It will go against Emily Cecil, and Fred Shamil now not happy.
Well, Cecil just checked into the game, and any player that checks in the game, you don't want to see him get a foul right away. And just a little sloppy there underneath the rim once again with Zekin and Cecil just not communicating on the right page. And Shamil definitely wasn't happy about it.
So Sidney McRae to the free throw line. Able to get the first. Northern Illinois continuing to keep this thing within a couple of scores, very similar to the Bowling Green Akron game we saw on Wednesday night. And McRae gets both this time. The Bowling Green lead cut to four. And with all the Bowling Green fouls over the last couple of minutes, you could say the Falcons living in defiance. Here's Velasco out on the right side. Back to Olivia Hill. Here's Paige Kohler. Emily Cecil. Back into the hands of Velasco. Here comes the junior trying to get to the rim. Couldn't get the first. Got her own offensive rebound. Here's Kohler on the outside after the pass from Hill. Kohler going down low, trying to get it to Zeke. Knocked away. Outside, Velasco for three. Lets it rain.
What an assist. Brandon off the foot and right into the hands of Amy Velasco.
56-49. McRae approaching the perimeter. Here's Cecil on defense. Nearly got by Cecil, but had to get the pass back off. Too long there out of the hands of Blumenfeld, who had a strong first half. With 8 points, has not scored here in the second half. Bowling Green settles it into the hands of Kohler. Kohler out on the right side. Picked up there by Nickel. Looking, surveying. Cecil, now to Velasco. Velasco back off to Kohler. Here's Emily Cecil once again. Had a three in the first half. Velasco, now Kohler going inside. Trying to get to the inside. Jump ball called. Possession arrow does favor Northern Illinois. 7-point Bowling Green lead, 1:43 left to play in the third quarter. And here comes McRae up the floor for the Huskies. Emily Cecil trying to pick her up there. The pass down low, left-handed try out of the hands of Nickel, in and out. And it's going to be knocked out of bounds. Last touched by Bowling Green. NIU will keep the basketball.
Yeah, I think they just rolled off the legs there at Paige Kohler, not being able to hold in that rebound.
So NIU will inbound from the baseline here. McRae looking in, gets it to Stauffacher. Tara Stauffacher back to Sydney McRae. Right in the same spot on the left wing. Now they'll spread things out. Here's Grace Hunter from the right side looking in. Fires to the left corner. That one was high in the air. Nickel had to go up to get it. Cuts the baseline and gets a nice underhanded finish there. Back within a two-score game once again. Here's Velasco up the floor. Both these teams have had plenty of trouble scoring this quarter. Kohler looks inside, turned away, now back behind the perimeter, gives to Olivia Hill. Hill off to Cecil. Here's Velasco cutting inside through two defenders. It would have been a good move had it gone, but Velasco can't get the bucket for Bowling Green. Nickel lost the basketball, but the Marshall, Wisconsin native able to track it back down. The Huskies back on offense. Here goes McRae to the inside. Tough defense there from Bowling Green that time. It goes out of bounds. Last touched by McRae. It'll be Bowling Green basketball. 35.4 left. A 5-point game. As we approach the end of the third quarter here, Jaden Marable going to come back on for Northern Illinois. She spent a lengthy amount of time off the floor here over the last couple of minutes.
And Marable has been one of the players for NIU that has gotten them more points in the paint this second half. They only had 8 points in the paint. At halftime, we've gotten six so far this third quarter, and she's been attacking inside.
4.5 seconds separating the shot clock from the game clock here. Bowling Green has the basketball in the hands of the freshman Kohler now. Kohler off to Velasco. Velasco guarded by Nickel. She'll go right back to Kohler. They'll defend her swap, and they'll continue to do the same thing on the perimeter. Down under 10 seconds on the shot clock. Here goes Velasco looking to the inside. Out of the left hand, it comes up short. Nickel the rebound. Down to 7 in the quarter. Nickel up the floor for Northern Illinois. Going to go to the inside. Fouled as she went to the basket. It will go on Amy Velasco. And for Velasco, that's going to be her third personal foul.
And we keep harping on it, not only this broadcast, but broadcast prior with the lack of available players Bowling Green has at their display right now. Anytime you get in their starting five in foul trouble, it can really hurt the team.
And Nickel. The first of two free throws. An opportunity here to cut it to a one-score game if she can get the second. Rebound! And the junior cannot get the second. Zeke in the rebound, throws it to Cecil. Half court heave coming. It was behind the whistle. And the third quarter will come to a close, 56-52. Bowling Green leads Northern Illinois. We've got one frame to play. 10 minutes will be loaded back onto the board. We will begin the fourth quarter. When we come back after the break, you're listening to Bowling Green Women's Basketball right here on 88.1 WBGU.
People join Walk MS to raise awareness and funds that change the world for everyone affected by multiple sclerosis. Walk MS brings communities together, creating teams with friends, loved ones, and coworkers to rally around those we care about and end MS forever. Together, we can change the world for people with MS. Register today at walkms.org.
Since the moment you were born, I've made 1,000 wishes. Wishes for your future in a world that's changing fast. Do play and laugh. Do win and lose. Do it all with confidence, kindness, and strength. And always do your best to remember that no matter what you do in this life, what matters to me is that you keep doing. Inspire kids to do at 4-H.org.
Dad, guess what?
What?
You are going to be a grandfather.
That's great. Not too long ago, moments like this with my daughter would have been a challenge. It was a long road for me to find myself again after Vietnam. It was my neighbor Jim, another Vietnam veteran, who finally convinced me that I could still connect with my family and find that fulfilling life I'd lost. And I went for help down at the VA. If I can take that first step after almost 50 years, I know other veterans can too. Visit maketheconnection.net to find out more.
When someone hears the words, you have cancer, it's one of the darkest moments in their life. Light the Night brings light to the darkness of cancer by uniting survivors, patients, and supporters in the cause to end cancer. We form a community of hope, raising funds in support of the Leukemia and Lymphoma Society. The discoveries made by LLS-supported research have led to breakthrough treatments for many cancers and other serious diseases. When we walk, cancer runs. Join the movement to end cancer today. Visit us at lightthenight.org.
Back here from the Convocation Center in DeKalb, Bowling Green leads by 4 in this one right now as we get ready to enter the fourth quarter, 56-52. Brandon Lowe, Lucas Kleinmeier back with you here on behalf of Falcon Media Sports Network and BG Falcon Media. Loaded day in Falcon Athletics right here on WBGU. And in this one, Bowling Green, they've had a lead for a majority of this contest, but it's really been, Lucas, a back-and-forth game.
It's been a back-and-forth game, and both teams have gone through streaks. They've gone through stretches where they've been dominant in the game. A typical Mid-American Conference basketball game where both teams enjoy scoring more than the other team. But right now for Bowling Green, 2 minutes and 22 seconds scoreless run to end that third quarter when they pretty much dominated majority of that third quarter, especially Paige Kohler, who played really well towards the start of that third quarter, getting to the free throw line and attacking the rim.
Bowling Green that quarter at the free throw line, 5 of 9, so 56%. But Bowling Green did get to the line more that quarter than they have all game. Velasco the basketball here as the Falcons start with it out of the break. Here's Paige Kohler now down to 13 on the shot clock. Kohler turning around, spinning, finding Velasco over the top of Stonebreaker there. Nice bucket for Velasco, who's up to 19 on the day. Here comes Marable up the floor for Northern Illinois. Sharps and Porter to the table to check in for the Falcons at the next whistle. Here comes Nickel the basketball, turning away from Kohler, now steps behind the perimeter. Laura Nickel. Back to Tara Stauffacher. Stauffacher inside. Nice little jump shot there from the left elbow. Finds the bottom of the barrel for Tara Stauffacher.
And while I know Husky players have scored a lot this game, the highest.
Kohler for three. PK-10 locked in there. She has gotten out to it in the third quarter. You mentioned she got to the free throw line a couple of times. A couple of buckets at the cup. And there takes it outside for that exterior game. Inside, knocked away. Stonebreaker there with the ball. Going to be fouled to the line for two here. Olivia Hill going to be whistled for the foul.
So as I was saying just earlier, Stonebreaker leads the Huskies with 11 points, but not really anyone scoring a whole lot of points for NIU since she leads with just 11. You got Drake with 6, Marble with 6, Blumenfeld with eight. It's been very spread very evenly with the Huskies.
So Stonebreaker at the free throw line, gets the first to go. Had 15 in the first contest against Bowling Green. Has 12 now on the free throw make. Gets the second to go as well. Bowling Green's lead is 5, 61-56. Here comes the Falcons up the floor once again. Here come the Falcons up the floor once again. Hill off the Sharks. Here's Paige Kohler. Moving away from McCray. Kohler behind the perimeter. Tried to go down low to Porter. It was knocked out of bounds by McCray. The Falcons will keep it. They'll inbound from the baseline here. On the inbound pass, Bowling Green likes to see if they can get it to Erica Porter in the low post. We'll see if they can do that this time. They will go directly into Porter. Back out to Velasco. Cutting inside. Out to Sharps. 4-3. Morgan Sharps off to the left side. Olivia Hill takes it out of the hands of Stonebreaker, and Stonebreaker going to be called for a foul, and that's her fourth.
That's what you love to see if you're a teammate of Olivia Hill and if you're Coach Shamil and the Falcons, just ripping that rebound away from NIU.
That was one of those that looked like it could have been called a jump ball, but Hill worked through it, able to rip it away. Porter down low for Bowling Green, trying to work through Stonebreaker, left-handed finish at the bucket. Erica Porter adds two more and becomes the fourth Bowling Green Falcon in two double figures. 63-56 now, Bowling Green opening that lead back up 7 points, their largest of the game. Stonebreaker over the top of Porter, could not get it to fall. Here comes Kohler back up the floor. Kohler looking, going inside, high off the glass. Paige Kohler gets it to go through, and Bowling Green's lead grows. And a timeout going to be called by Lisa Carlson and the Huskies. 65-56, Bowling Green leads. And of course, all timeouts brought to you by Juniper Brewing Company, located at 145 South Main Street in downtown Bowling Green, featuring coffee and craft beer, serving breakfast, lunch, and dinner. See the latest menu at juniperbrew.com. The Falcons have a 9-point lead. 2 minutes into the fourth quarter. We'll step aside. You're listening to Bowling Green Women's Basketball right here on 88.1 WBGU.
Sweet strawberry icing. You're in Goodwill and just past that vintage denim jacket, you spot miniature donut earrings. You lean in. Ah. That's the scent of shopping success. Because at Goodwill, every item you buy funds local job training and more. So bring home those donut earrings and bring home so much good to your community. Goodwill, bring good home. Brought to you by Goodwill and the Ad Council.
BGSU outfielder Nathan Archer is coming into the 2024 baseball season as a contender for MAC Player of the Year. Archer earned himself MAC All-Second Team and MAC All-Defensive Team honors last season after hitting .282 with an .854 OPS and team-leading 9 home runs and posting a perfect 1,000 fielding percentage. Archer hit even better in the 2022 season as he recorded a .317 batting average on top of a .962 OPS and 8 home runs. Nathan was an all-conference and all-county player as a four-time varsity letter winner at Keystone High School with a .583 average from 16 RBIs as a senior. Archer's ability to produce on the field both offensively and defensively is what makes him such a threat in the MAC this season and in the future as a professional baseball player. This has been 60 Seconds in Falcon Athletics on 88.1 FM WBGU, Northwest Ohio's community radio station.
Standing up for what's right, helping out when things go wrong, seeking the truth and speaking our minds, not just making records, but breaking them. Leading the way behind the camera, beyond the runway, and on the silver screen. Not just making our mark, but making a difference. Now that's a job for a Girl Scout. Girl Scouts, preparing girls for a lifetime of leadership.
Most of us like to be out in the sun. That's why sunscreen and other safety measures are key to protecting your skin from aging and cancer. The FDA recommends using a sunscreen with an SPF of 15 or higher. Also, look for broad spectrum on the label. That means both harmful ultraviolet A and B rays are blocked. Remember, SPF plus broad spectrum equal healthy fun in the sun. Visit www.fda.gov/sunscreen for more information. A message from the U.S. Food and Drug Administration.
Back here from DeKalb, and Bowling Green has the lead, their largest of the game, by 9 points right now, 65-56. Brandon LaLucas, Kleinmeier back with you here. Another presentation of Bowling Green women's basketball brought to you by the Falcon Media Sports Network and BG Falcon Media. Inside, Blumenfeld over the top, tries to get two there, fading away, could not get it to go. Here's the last go back across the timeline as Bowling Green takes over. Marable, the tight defense there. Bowling Green playing four with three fouls right now. Velasco the basketball here out on the right side. Looking down low, trying to get it to Porter. Inside, Stoffker defending. Porter comes back out. Kohler, now here's Sharps. Tried to get it back to Velasco. It was knocked away by Northern Illinois. Here comes Marable up the floor. Jaden Marable to the inside. Back out McCray for three. Looking at it, getting after it. Sydney McCray knocks it down.
For the Huskies, that's how you're going to get back into this game is you get stops on the defensive end and you hit from downtown.
Velasco going inside, left it short, but fouled. A foul going to be called. Waiting to see where this one will be assessed. It will go on Jaden Marable. That's her third foul of the game. And it'll be Amy Velasco headed to the free throw line. So Velasco in her trips today. 2 of 2. Bowling Green has been to the line now after these two 15 times today. And Velasco hits both. And Bowling Green trying to extend that lead here as this fourth quarter moves along. They had an 18-point victory over Northern Illinois the first time, we mentioned. Trying to do that again, but Northern Illinois had been playing some good basketball. Coming in, Nickel inside, offensive foul. That'll give Bowling Green the basketball back once again. So the Falcons here, a chance to get a double-figure lead for the first time this game. Velasco moves it forward to Porter on the outside. Here comes Kohler. Kohler, some space between she and Nickel right now. Sharps trying to get open. McCray there to defend. Kohler back to Sharps. Here's Velasco once again. Velasco calls for Kohler. The trio continues to move it around on the outside for Bowling Green. Kohler trying to get it to Velasco, knocked away. Four on the shot clock. Velasco takes the three and knocks it down. Amy Velasco having a game. She's up to 22 points. Jaden Marable here gets it rid of it. Blumenfeld has it now, off the Nickel. Stonebreaker on the bench is huge right now for Northern Illinois. They'd love to put her out on the floor, but she's got four fouls. Nickel going inside, trying to twist through the defense. Back out, McCray for three once again. That one off the mark, but an offensive rebound. Northern Illinois will keep the basketball. Blumenfeld on the inside, going to work on Porter. Throws it across. Here's Marable now, working inside, trying to get around Kohler. Easier said than done, but Marable gets it done and gets to the inside. Bowling Green's 11-point lead, cut to nine there on the Northern Illinois basket from Marable. Velasco loses her dribble, finds Sharps. Morgan Sharps backing away behind the perimeter once again. Back off to Kohler. The Falcons continuing to wind time down. Hill comes open under the basket. Olivia Hill gets a bucket. Then her second of the game.
Only her second bucket of the game, but she's been the unsung hero of this game. Her defensive play this game has been outstanding, and she's played a team high 31 minutes as well.
Inside, Nickel blocked by Hill right there. You just talked about it, and right on cue, there's Olivia Hill once again. Northern Illinois cannot wait any longer. They'll have to bring Brooke Stonebreaker back into this game. Down 11 here with 5:12 to play. Marable off the inbound pass from the baseline here, gives it to Nickel. Nickel trying to drive down low, fires into the corner. McCray was there, Sharps in tight. Doesn't allow McCray to get the shot off. Down low under the basket. Stonebreaker got it to Nickel. Still working through the two forwards for Bowling Green. But right there, Velasco takes it away. She's been another one that her steals are racking up today. Amy Velasco up to six steals this game right now. Velasco around the outside. Gives it off to Kohler. Here's Sharps for three. Ooh. Off a hair to the right side. And Fred Shamil wanting his team to take time off the clock now. Marable inside, going after it. Velasco hands straight up. Porter on the floor going after the loose ball. And we've got bodies all over the floor right now. McCray was down there. Porter was down there. Jump ball going to be called. And I believe it's going to be Northern Illinois basketball.
And you mentioned Shamil wanting his team to take more time off the clock. Right now, you have 4:24 left. You have an 11-point lead. That's what you're going to have to do. I mean, you don't really need to extend the lead anymore unless you want to get an open shot.
So Marable will inbound from the baseline. 4:24 left to play here in the fourth quarter. 72-61, Bowling Green leads. Grace Hunter trying to come open. Travel going to be called on the Huskies. That gives Bowling Green the basketball back.
And Pages on defense can cause them to make mistakes just like that.
Velasco here bringing the basketball forward. Over the top to Porter. Here's Kohler. Paige Kohler on the outside. Bowling Green taking time off the clock. Down under 4:10 to play. Here's Velasco looking inside. Right-handed finish at the basket. Amy Velasco adds two more to her point total for the day, up to 26. Marable down low, Stonebreaker. A big part of the identity for this Northern Illinois team. Stonebreaker out of the left hand, off the inside of the rim, back out into the hands of Porter. Kohler slowing things down. 3:40 left to play. Bowling Green a 13-point lead. To Porter, low on the ground. The Falcons after it. Porter able to get the pass off. Three bodies to the floor there, and a timeout going to be taken by Fred Shamil. Another one of our timeouts brought to you by our official 2023-2024 timeout sponsor, Juniper Brewing Company. 74-61, just a quick timeout here of the 32nd variety for Bowling Green. A brief discussion here to talk things over. And how about the day for Amy Velasco thus far? 26 points, a trio of rebounds and assists, but six steals for the junior on a 9 of 18 shooting performance. An excellent day for Amy Velasco.
She's been fantastic in this game, especially in this quarter. She's been the closer, really, for the Falcons. And she's earned a couple of offensive fouls on the defensive end for Bowling Green as well. She's been great. And like you mentioned, you just went through her stats, playing also a team-high 34 minutes with Olivia Hill.
So Morgan Sharps will inbound here for Bowling Green. Out of the timeout, there will be 12 on the shot clock for Bowling Green. Stauffacher to guard the inbound pass. Right in the face of Sharps, kick ball violation. Bowling Green will have to do it again. And that's all that Stauffacher's job is there, is to present an obstacle in the way of Morgan Sharps. Ball into Amy Velasco. Foul going to be called on Marable. And for Marable, that's her fourth.
And Marable and Stonebreaker, your two most important players, especially on the offensive end, now with one foul away from fouling out, and that's not what you want for the Huskies.
So Velasco to inbound from the baseline after the floor foul by Jaden Marable. Into the corner, Olivia Hill. Back to Velasco. Velasco will bring it away. It was 20 seconds on the shot clock when she passed the ball in. So still 10 on it now. Here's Kohler. Back into the hands of Velasco, behind the perimeter, down low, looking for Porter, trying to fight through a double team, and a travel called as Porter shuffled the feet. Northern Illinois will continue to make some changes. Sydney McCray going to come on for Grace Hunter. Bowling Green still controls by 13 with 3:12 left to play. Northern Illinois will try to preserve some time as Marable picks up the ball as it gets towards the timeline. Stonebreaker on the outside. McCray calling for it down low. Stonebreaker didn't like the look. Back to Marable inside with a right hand right off the white square and down through the bucket. Northern Illinois, a much needed bucket there after being scoreless for the last 2.5 minutes. Here's Velasco once again for Bowling Green into the hands of Kohler. Kohler looking corner. Morgan Sharps there, guarded by McCray. Sharps looking inside, back to Velasco, pulls up there. Amy Velasco knocks it down once again, up to 28 points on the day. Maribel comes out of the backcourt side by side with Stonebreaker, both playing on four fouls now, but trying to mount a Northern Illinois charge here. Stonebreaker has the basketball once again just beyond the charity stripe. McCray calling for it, trying to get open. That one goes outside here. Stomfaker for three, and that one rings through the rim. And a timeout going to be called by Northern Illinois. Bowling Green, a 10-point lead, 76-66. And we will take this one with them. Another one of our timeouts brought to you by Juniper Brewing Company. Bowling Green by 10, 76-66. You're listening to Bowling Green Women's Basketball right here on 88.1 WBGU.
Brad's buzzed.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah, he's starting with the woots.
Woot, woot.
And now a speech.
I just want to say that friendship is about heart. Heart and brain. Who's with me?
Good thing is, he knows when he's buzzed.
And my brain is saying, when it's time to go home, somebody call me a ride.
Love that guy.
Me too.
Know your buzzed warning signs? Call for a ride when it's time to go home. Buzz driving is drunk driving. A message from NHTSA and the Ad Council.
Tom has been a teacher for over 40 years. One day, I think one of the students had asked the question and he didn't remember the answer. And I also noticed that he was letting his class out earlier than they were supposed to let out. I was really starting to worry.
Levi and I talked about how it would change our lives, but he was there beside me.
When something feels different, it could be Alzheimer's. Now is the time to talk. Visit alz.org/ourstories to learn more. A message from the Alzheimer's Association and the Ad Council.
Adopt US Kids presents What to Expect When You're Expecting a Teenager. Learning the lingo.
Jelly. Jelly adjective. Jelly is a shorter, better way to say jealous. As in, Chloe, I am like so jelly of your unicorn phone case.
You don't have to speak teen to be a perfect parent. Thousands of teens in foster care will love you just the same. Visit AdoptUSKids.org. Brought to you by the US Department of Health and Human Services, Adopt US Kids, and the Ad Council.
Foul going to be called on Northern Illinois here as we come back out of the break. It'll be the first foul of the game that's going to go against Sydney McCray. Erica Porter going to head to the free throw line. 2:07 left to play in the fourth quarter. Brandon Lowe, Lucas Kleinmeier back with you here courtside in the Kalb. And Porter gets the first one through. Needed every part of the iron and the glass to get that one to fall through, but Erica Porter does get it to go home. 3 of 5 today, looking and lining up the second one here. Could not get that one, so a 50% trip and a 50% day for Porter right now at the line. Bowling Green leads by 11, 77-66. On the outside, Maribel gets rid of the basketball, back and forth with Stonebreaker. Here's McCray now on the outside, off a screen from Stoffaker, looking to find an opening down low, looking for Stonebreaker, tipped out of bounds by Bowling Green. It will be Northern Illinois basketball.
And for Bowling Green now, got 11-point lead with under 2 minutes left. Don't want to do anything sloppy or giving away any silly fouls. Got 2 minutes left. Just kind of run this clock out.
Stonebreaker gets rid of it quickly off the inbound pass. Stoffaker on the outside looks down low. They want to get it to Stonebreaker, but Stonebreaker gives it back out to Maribel. Maribel to the inside, left-handed and one. Jaden Maribel gets it to fall, and Velasco called for a foul. That is her fourth of the game.
Like I just mentioned, I mean, you don't want to give them silly fouls, or especially and ones. Off that, Maribel did a really good job there getting to the rim and getting that shot to go, but Velasco there just needs to be a little bit more careful there with the contact.
So Jaden Maribel to the free throw line. Left it short of the rim. Basketball comes back out. Velasco able to recover it for Bowling Green. She will stand near the timeline. Basketball firmly in hand with a 9-point lead at her back. Here's Kohler. Back to Velasco, and a foul going to be called there. It will be another one on McCray. So that will put Amy Velasco at the free throw line once again. And guess what? Perfect from the line today. A 4 of 4 performance in what has been a 28-point performance for Bowling Green. Velasco gets the first. Trying to make it a 30-piece here. And does. Amy Velasco gets it to fall through. 30 points for Bowling Green. She will check out Emily Cecil. comes back in for Bowling Green. And a new career high for points for Amy Velasco. It was 28 against Ball State earlier this season, now 30 here today against Northern Illinois. The Huskies rattle one home there. Jaden Marable gets another one to fall, and it's still a single-digit game. Hill looking to get it in. There's Kohler. Kohler caught up by the double team, fires forward. Here's Porter. Porter to Sharps. And Sharps going to be fouled. They will send Morgan Sharps to the free throw line. Foul on Courtney Drake.
And just a touchback on what you said about Velasco. She's earned it. This has been definitely one of the best all-around games she's had so far this season. From start to finish, she hasn't missed a step at all. Offensively and defensively, she's been excellent for Bowling Green.
Two new career highs for Amy Velasco today with 30 points and six steals. So a well-rounded day as well. Sharps could not get the first at the free throw line. 103 left to play. Bowling Green does lead by nine, trying to make it a double-digit lead, and it's through. 80-70. But Northern Illinois not going away yet. Here's Marable up the floor, off to Stonebreaker. McCray coming over off a screen, lets the three fly. That one came up short, loose under the basket. And we will get a foul on the floor. Who's it going to be assessed to? Erica Porter for Bowling Green picks up her fourth foul of the game.
Be interesting to see if she checks out here. Velasco is on four. She may elect to send her to the bench. We'll see what happens.
So Marable to inbound on the baseline. Gets it in. Stonebreaker again. Now it's Marable cutting to the inside, trying to get around Cecil. And a foul going to be called. That will go against Emily Cecil. It'll be her third. Laura Nickel comes back in for Courtney Drake. So Jaden Marable will have two shots at the line here as Northern Illinois is down 10. Marable at the free throw line today. Missed her only attempt. Able to get the second. Bowling Green will likely call a timeout here after the second free throw. Marable could not hit the second. Bowling Green calls a timeout. And they will talk things over. Just a 30-second timeout for Bowling Green. They lead 80-71 with 47.8 left to go here in the fourth quarter. And while it's not over yet for Bowling Green, it looks like they are getting closer to picking up their eighth Mid-American Conference victory of the season.
For sure, and they should be proud, especially of the second half performance. It's been a very close game throughout. It's been back and forth. There hasn't been a humongous lead from either Bowling Green or NIU, and they've just done business here in this second half. I think you've shown signs of teams that have players on this team that are experienced playing in big games before and closing out games like this towards the end of the season when there's only five games left in the season and everyone wants to get to Cleveland and get a high seed, and Bowling Green's trying to do just that.
And for the remainder of this one, Bowling Green, any foul will put the Falcons at the free throw line. Velasco to inbound to Hill. Going to get it right back to Velasco, and she's going to go to the free throw line. Foul on McCray. And it'll be McCray's third. And Velasco going to get to go to the charity stripe once again to continue to improve on what has already been a career performance. Reminder coming up after the game, we'll be joined by Bowling Green assistant coach Maggie Lucas and Amy Velasco, our player of the game, for today's game against Northern Illinois. And then coming up tomorrow, you'll be able to hear me talk a little bit more about Bowling Green women's basketball on the Zig Zone at 4 o'clock. You'll be able to hear all about your Bowling Green sports recaps from this past week, whether it's hockey, men's basketball, or women's basketball. We will have that all covered tomorrow at 4 o'clock right here on 88.1 WBGU. Velasco able to get both free throws at the line. She'll come back off the floor here. And Northern Illinois, Stofker and Marable going to try to go quick here. Time winding down. Marable the basketball. Northern Illinois going very slow for a team that's looking to find 11 points here in the last minute. McCray to the inside does bury it with the left hand. And a timeout going to be called by Bowling Green once again. And Amy Velasco is going to check back in for the Falcons once again, a 9-point lead. Now I'll get to go back to what I was saying. We mentioned the Zig Zone tomorrow at 4 o'clock. Also the rebroadcast, which you worked closely to helping produce, of the 1984 championship game, the third period, and all the overtimes. That'll be tomorrow night at, I believe, 9 o'clock on WBGU.
Correct, yep. Sunday, tomorrow night at 9 p.m., you can listen to the rebroadcast of the 1984 NCAA Hockey National Championship. That was honestly one of my favorite things I've worked on so far here at Bowling Green. Ben Korak, the voice of BG Hockey, myself, Phil Bezkid, Carl Smith. A lot of factors came in to trying to bring this rebroadcast to life, but it could not have been done without the Cooling Center engineers, Chad Fletcher and Jim Barnes. They did fantastic work retrieving that audio, getting it out of the tape and rebroadcasting it as well, and making it's pretty clear audio as well. I don't know if you tune into one Thursday night. If you haven't, for listeners at home, definitely tune in Sunday night to listen to it. It's fantastic with Joe Bornstein, Joan Bowers on the call. One of the greatest moments in BGSU Lex history. I'm so glad we got a chance to rebroadcast it. It's fantastic.
And you mentioned the work by the engineer staff. It was actually in an old cassette tape that was pretty much unusable that they were able to salvage the tape. They took out the little microchip and put it in a brand new cassette in order to transcribe it so we could get it into use. Sharps the basketball, gets it off to Velasco. And Amy Velasco in the middle still has the basketball. She'll pick it up and give it to Kohler. McCray not fouling here. Northern Illinois will get the basketball back, but just 20 left on the clock. McCray fires forward to Stonebreaker, taken away by Sharps. And that will be the end of this basketball game. Sharps gives it to Kohler. They'll bring it back forward. And that will do it. Bowling Green picks up their eighth Mid-American Conference victory of the season, their second in a row. They win the week 2-0 in games against Akron and Northern Illinois. So we will step aside quickly and launch into the Bowling Green Women's Basketball postgame show, where we will be joined by Bowling Green assistant coach Maggie Lucas. You're listening to Bowling Green Women's Basketball right here on 88.1 WBGU.
All the talks we've had over the years, including what you've told me about not using alcohol and other drugs, they stick with me. And believe it or not, they really do make a difference, especially at times that matter most.
Hey, want a drink?
No thanks, I'm good. So thank you, Dad, for talking and preparing me for what's ahead.
Thank you for talking.
For more information about talking with your kids about underage use of alcohol and other drugs, visit underagedrinking.samhsa.gov.
If you suffer from COPD symptoms like shortness of breath and fatigue, where do you turn? There are medications and oxygen, but do you know about pulmonary rehab? 3 out of 5 COPD patients have never heard of it. Pulmonary rehab is an exercise, education, and support program that gives you tools to manage your condition, and Medicare typically pays for it. So whether it's grocery shopping on your own or just walking across the room, pulmonary rehab can help you. Visit livebetter.org to find out about your options for pulmonary rehab today.
Hey, I'm Camden North, and you're listening to 88.1 FM WBGU Bowling Green, home of the Falcon Media Sports Network.
Hey guys, it's Jason here, with the Falcon 4 Amazing Quotes with Coach Simon. You got the classic one, come on now, what are we doing? Second one, another one during the game, you're going to be yelling, rebound! And then, you know, typical breakdown in practice. We got a step dribble hop move, you know, one of the best moves in basketball. And then, you know, if coach ever wants something good to eat, got to go with the nacho fries.
Hi, it's Olivia Munn with my shelter pets, Frankie and Chance. Say hi, guys. When I adopted them, I discovered that they both have incredible personalities. Chance's sole purpose in life is to love and to be loved. Frankie is a little bit of a scoundrel and always entertaining. They're a little bit of a lot of things, but they're all pure love. Adopt pure love at theshelterpetproject.org. Brought to you by the Ad Council, the Humane Society of the United States, and Maddie's Fund.
Some knowledge belongs to us and us alone. The way our girlfriends walk, talk, touch their hair. Details that only a sister can know about her girls. But what about our other girls? The ones we carry with us every day. Our bond with our sister girls gives life. But knowing your breasts can save it. Go to knowyourgirls.org for the facts you need on breast health. Brought to you by Susan G. Komen and the Ad Council.
WBG Falcon fans, you're here with Paige Kohler on the women's basketball team. These are my Falcon 4 favorite things about basketball. First off, I love competing. I love being able to win, and I love the winning feeling. Second, I love that it's a team sport. I love being out there with four other people on the court. Third, all the traveling that we get to do. I've been to so many new places because of basketball. And lastly, I love making new friends and just playing the sport I love with my best friends.
Return to Radio Freedom with 88.1 FM WBGU. Northwest Ohio's community radio station offers local programming from the morning show to eclectic music shows from a variety of genres and local sports coverage. So keep it locked in right here on 88.1 FM or stream us live 24/7 on bgfalconmedia.com and the TuneIn Radio app. 88.1 FM WBGU, Northwest Ohio's community radio station.
Melissa from Michigan. I work an extra part-time job serving lunch at my child's school, but I still can't afford to put food on our table.
Daniel from California. Choosing whether to pay the rent or pay to fix the car to get to work doesn't leave us with much at all. Now we can't even pay for meals.
Hunger is a story we can end. End it at feedingamerica.org. Brought to you by Feeding America and the Ad Council.
Hi, this is Tom Hamilton, voice of the Cleveland Indians. You're listening to all the high-flying action of Falcon Sports on 88.1 WBG.
Back here from the Convocation Center in DeKalb, Illinois, joined now by Bowling Green assistant coach Maggie Lucas following Bowling Green's big victory today over Northern Illinois. Coach, as always, we just take us through your initial thoughts on today's game.
Yeah, I mean, it was, you know, back and forth for the majority of the game. But, you know, I thought, you know, we had just, I mean, Amy's been amazing for us all season long. You know, that showed today, and she was a difference maker. You know, I think we were able to get downhill offensively, which was really big for us, and get some good movement side to side. And that really opened up things for us offensively. Defensively, you know, we knew coming into this game we had to guard the three-point line, and they came out really hot. They shoot it incredibly well. And, you know, so we had to, you know, lock in on that as the game went on. But big plays down the stretch by everybody, and, you know, we're going to need everybody to come in and contribute and be ready to lock in and lock down wins. And I thought, you know, anytime you can win on the road, that's huge.
And I know one of the things we've talked about is, you know, the lack of depth there over the adversity that you guys have had to battle with injuries and everything that's come with that this season. But you got solid minutes out of Emily Cecil today as well, and she, you know, accounted into the scoring factor. I mean, what does it do for you guys when you have someone that can come in off the bench like that, play 20 minutes in the game, and contribute the way she did today?
I mean, it says, you know, Emily, she's been, you know, just so selfless all season long, and, you know, she does whatever we ask her to do, and she's prepared all season long, you know, as though she's going to play 19 minutes. And, you know, today, you know, that showed up. You know, she works her butt off every single day, and coming in, knocking down a big three, cleaned up a couple rebounds. I think she had two assists as well. You know, that's big. And, you know, she also on the defensive end really, you know, worked hard and contributed in a big way as well.
We have talked about how the Mid-American Conference seems like it's a night-by-night basis of anybody can beat anybody. But we've also talked about how this portion of the schedule is a nice build-up for you guys into the conference tournament with the teams that you're going to see over the coming weeks. Next up, coming up on Wednesday, you're going to have Buffalo. Chella Watson had 36 points against you guys the first time out. What's sort of the game plan there in terms of the way you guys attack the Bulls defensively coming up this Wednesday?
You know, she's an incredible player, and she's a great scorer. She's got a great knack for scoring the ball. So, you know, it's a big job, and it's not going to fall on one person. So we're going to, you know, get a great game plan together and get back to work and get ready for the next one.
Well, another big victory today, Coach, your second in a row. Congrats on the big victory, and thank you for your time.
Thank you.
So we will step aside here on the Bowling Green Women's Basketball postgame show. Lucas Kleinmeier will hop back on the mic. We'll talk final stats, and then we'll be joined by our player of the game this evening, of course, Miss Amy Velasco. You're listening to Bowling Green Women's Basketball right here on 88.1 WBGU.
Did you know that people born from 1945 to 1965 have the highest rates of hepatitis C, but most don't know they're infected? People can live for decades without symptoms, but over time, hepatitis C can cause serious health problems, including liver damage and even liver cancer. If you were born from 1945 to 1965, The CDC recommends that you get a blood test for hepatitis C. So talk to your doctor about getting tested. It could save your life. A message from the CDC.
All over America, people are taking the national radon test. Have you? Answer true or false. Radon is a radioactive gas. True.
I didn't know that, no.
True or false. The Office of the Surgeon General recommends that all homes be tested for radon. True, your home should be tested. True or false, radon is the second leading cause of lung cancer. True.
I'm gonna dial the number and call.
1-800-SOS-RADON.
Keep your family safe from radon. Call now.
1-800-SOS-RADON.
Back here from DeKalb, the Convocation Center following Bowling Green's 82-73 victory over the Northern Illinois Huskies. A big one today, their second in a row, their eighth Mid-American Conference victory of the season. Lucas Kleinmeier back on the headset to my left to talk final stats with us and take us through some of the other games around the Mid-American Conference. Obviously, this one important in the way that Bowling Green is going to play out the rest of this season. But some other important games around the Mid-American Conference, including today, a first-place showdown between Ball State and Toledo.
Yeah, and, you know, that was the game to watch if all the other teams are looking for in this conference. These are two Titans in the conference. Toledo beating Ball State 70-48. That's a surprise in itself. And Ball State and Toledo are going to be battling to finish first in the regular season for the MAC to get that first seed when the Cleveland comes around. But it's a shocker, especially if Ball State, that's their fourth loss of the season. And only 48 points, and they were held to only 6 points in that first quarter. And kind of a shocker.
Yeah, I think that's a big game in terms of Ball State. You know, they started 10-0 in Mid-American Conference play, and, you know, they were in first place, and now they lost to Northern Illinois, this Northern Illinois team that Bowling Green beat today. And then Toledo trounces them today by 22 points, so a big game for Trisha Cullop and the Toledo Rockets as they now have sole possession of first place in the Mid-American Conference, so that's big for Toledo. But talking in terms of what happened today in this game for Bowling Green, for Northern Illinois, we'll visit their stats first. Three players in double figures, Brooke Stonebreaker, Jaden Marable, and Sydney McCray as well, got into, you know, double figures for Northern Illinois. And what was an all-around day, everyone that played scored, but for Bowling Green, they could not top four players in double figures, including a 32-point career-high performance from Amy Velasco on a night she was 8 of 8 from the free throw line and also set a new career-high with 6 steals in the game.
Yeah, I think just really the biggest difference between these two teams this game was just the points off turnovers. Bowling Green had 19 points off turnovers. Final NIU only had 8. In a game that was pretty close all throughout, that was probably the difference.
So we will step aside one more time here from the Convocation Center. When we come back, our player of the game, Amy Velasco, will join us here. You're listening to the Bowling Green Women's Basketball postgame show right here on 88.1 WBGU.
Women Heart is in a race to save lives. Heart disease is the number one killer of women. It's 80% preventable if you know the facts. Millions of women are living with or at risk of heart disease. Get educated. See your doctor. Know the facts. To win this race, we all have to do it together. Our hearts beat as one. To learn more, visit womenheart.org.
The average time a resume spends on an HR manager's desk is 7 seconds, and most of them are tossed aside. Now imagine if one of those resumes belonged to Yasmin, who was
living in a shelter, juggling 3 jobs. I had to be resilient. That's something that you can't teach.
We rely so much on a resume, yet it could never tell the full story of someone who
had to be independent and take initiative, and that's how I handle every project I get.
Discover new ways to develop great talent at gradsoflife.org, brought to you by Grads of Life and the Ad Council.
Welcome back to The Dog Show. Up next, we have Satchmo. Satchmo is a member of the Shelter Pet Group.
That's right, a group known especially for their couch-snuggling, ball-chasing, face-licking, and, of course, companionship. Now, let's see him in action.
Look how he makes eye contact with his person.
That's actually known as the treat stare.
How intuitive, and now he appears to be excitedly turning in circles.
Ah, the happy dance so common with this group.
But really, the best way to know an amazing shelter pet like Satchmo is to meet one.
Visit theshelterpetproject.org today. Adopt.
Brought to you by Maddie's Fund, the Humane Society of the United States, and the Ad Council.
Back here at the Convocation Center in Northern Illinois, following Bowling Green's 82-73 victory over the Northern Illinois Huskies. Joined now by Bowling Green's player of the game, our Falcon Media Sports Network player of the game tonight, Amy Velasco, a new career high with 32 points and a new career high with steals, six steals. Did you sleep good last night?
Yeah, I must have slept good. I must have slept good, right? Yeah, today was a lot of fun.
So take us through, you know, we always ask Coach to take us through their perspective on the game. What did you see out there on the floor?
Yeah, I think today we worked really, really well together. We played great team basketball. We held it through the whole clock. You know, we didn't take quick shots. And even when we did, I think we realized that we just need to get it to both sides of the floor and just take our time, and the shots will come.
It seemed like initially out of the first quarter, which you guys led 9 of the first 10 minutes of this game, but Northern Illinois ended the first quarter with the lead. It seemed like it was going to be one of those days where you were going to have to deal with the three ball again, just like Wednesday when Akron went 12 of 25. I mean, what does that do to your mindset in terms of what you have to do defensively to sort of change the landscape of the game and how offenses are attacking you?
Yeah, for sure. We came into this game knowing they're a great three-point shooting team, and one of our keys was defend the three-point line. So we knew we had to lock in, you know, after that first quarter and kind of take away those open looks from threes because they're great shooters.
In terms of the offense now, two wins in a row, two good offensive performances. I mean, you started 5 of 5 from the floor today, and you really kept that going all the way throughout. Nice little bursts in the third and fourth quarter as well. Four players in double figures. I mean, that you've got four of the top 15 scorers in Mid-American Conference play on the same team, on the same time at the floor together. I mean, what does that do for you guys to know you have scoring options in every single pass you make?
Oh, yeah, for sure. Our team, there's always someone on the floor that can score the basketball, whether that be E inside, and she draws a lot of people. You probably see in the past couple games that every time we throw it into her, she's getting two, three girls on her, which opens up the rest of the floor. So it's a really cool dynamic we have on our team, and I just love playing with these girls.
So now you've got two wins in a row. You've got four games left before the Mid-American Conference Tournament, obviously trying to rise up the standings. I know I told you this off the air, but Toledo beats Ball State. So now they're in first. Ball State's in second. Kent State. And then you guys in Buffalo are the 4-5 right now. Buffalo has the tiebreaker being the first matchup. But you guys are going to play them again on Wednesday. What are your initial thoughts on getting to play that team for the second time this season?
Yeah. I'm excited to play them again. And obviously it's a big game. It's meaningful. You know, we're tied, like you said. They have a little bit over the tiebreaker. So we just need to go in, work hard into these next few practices, and be ready to play come Wednesday.
Big-time games coming up down the stretch for Bowling Green Women's Hoops, and a big-time performance from Amy Velasco today. Amy, congrats on another great individual performance and a great team win.
Thank you.
So that will do it for us here in DeKalb today. We will be hustling away from the broadcast table. Big thank yous go out to Steve Iwanek, the sports director, Carl Smith, the Falcon Media Advisor, Bowling Green Athletics Sports Information Director Mike Sheehan, Lucas Kleinmeier, the guy right to my left, colored today, got him out here on a road trip, could be the possible voice of women's basketball in the future. Back in the studio, Sean Connolly, the board op, pushing the buttons and putting us through. Make sure you check out another Falcon Media Sports Network production tonight. Ben Korak, Nick Bowers, the current Falcon Media Sports Network members on the call for BG Falcon Hockey. Tomorrow, the Zig Zone will have everybody, Tyler Kavalitz, Ben Korak, myself, all the voices or beats of the certain winter sports. We're going to be in the studio talking shop on the Zig Zone. Make sure you catch that. And then, of course, the rebroadcast tomorrow night as well. So all important notes here as we exit the postgame show. But Bowling Green, a big 82-73 victory over Northern Illinois today. Make it two straight in the eighth Mid-American Conference victory of the season. For all the people that I've mentioned previously and all the things coming up that you have to look forward to, I'm Brandon Lowe saying so long from DeKalb. Bowling Green women's basketball victorious again as they knock off the Northern Illinois Huskies.
The following broadcast has been the presentation of Bowling Green Athletics. For more information of BG Falcon Athletics schedules, news, and other information, please visit bgsufalcons.com. This has also been a production of the Falcon Media Sports Network. For a schedule and up-to-date broadcast information, be sure to find us on Twitter with the username @BGRSO, as well as going to our website, bgfalconmedia.com, for a complete broadcast schedule, programming guide, broadcaster biographies, and news on Falcon Athletics.